At Beck's, we are farmers at heart. For over 100 years, the Beck family has lived and farmed in central Indiana. We are proud to announce Saline River Seed, your dedicated Beck's dealers now serving farmers in northwest Kansas. At Beck's, we are committed to helping farmers seek new challenges, push boundaries, and innovate in an ever-changing industry. That's what makes Beck's different. For more information, call your Beck's local dealer, Darren Roberts, at 785-299-0126.
Harmony Farms Kansas is a sixth-generation family farm located in Decatur County, Kansas. It was founded in 1878, and we still farm the original homestead. Harmony Farms Kansas has been certified organic since 1987, and we're certified by the Organic Crop Improvement Association, National Organic Producers, and in Canada, with the U.S.-Canadian Equivalency Program. Harmony Farms offers certified organic wheat, milo, and millet, both in bulk and individual packaging, along with individual bags of whole wheat flour. Harmony Farms Kansas, a proud supporter of Quinter Schools.
Family Market in downtown Quinter is here to provide fuel for bulldogs of all ages. Come in and check out our variety of fresh produce, the large selection from the meat department, or food from the deli section. Offering weekly specials, Family Market has your family covered. Shop local, where we provide friendly smiles, a warm welcome, and service you can't find elsewhere. Family Market, a locally owned grocery store, is a proud supporter of all things Bulldog and Bulldog Athletics.
Kinder Sires Barnes is your farm bureau agent, serving the area since 2008. Give her team a call today to learn how they can make it easy to protect things that are most important to you, your home, family, farm, and future. Kinder's team is committed to offering quality products and exceptional service. If you have questions, they are just a phone call away. Kinder appreciates the opportunity to earn your business, and she and the team look forward to showing you how simple insurance can be.
GG&T Cattle Company is a fourth generation seed stock producer owned and operated by Cindy, Garrett, Crystal, Reed, and Jessica Worth. They specialize in registered Slayers, Angus, and Optimizer cattle. Join GG&T for the 49th annual production sale on February 22nd, 2024 at their ranch south of Quinter. GG&T Cattle Company, proud supporters of the Quinter Bulldogs.
Gove Community Bible Church, located in Gove, Kansas, is a Jesus-driven community that is proud to support the Quinter Bulldogs. We offer worship on Sunday mornings at 10:30 a.m. If you would like to know more about our church, visit our website at www.govecbc.com or download our Faith Life app from the QR code. Be sure to follow us on Facebook as well. Good luck, Bulldogs!
Gove County Medical Center is your 24-hour critical access hospital, located in Quinter, Kansas. Since 1925, GCMC has been providing outstanding health care to Northwest Kansas with services such as surgery, physical therapy, radiology, podiatry, orthopedics, lab, and much more. For the right care, at the right time, in the right place close to home, call 785-754-3341. GCMC is committed to others, always. Proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Kansas Land Bank is a locally owned community bank supporting community and school events. They are a full-service bank offering everything from ag loans to personal savings and checking accounts. Kansas Land Bank has a friendly staff that provides that personal touch. As one of the few locally owned community banks left in western Kansas, they strive to serve the needs of the people in our area. Kansas Land Bank remains a proud supporter of all Bulldog activities.
Mann Farms is your local AgriGold agent. For over 80 years, AgriGold has delivered quality corn and soybean seed to growers with unmatched genetic innovation and performance, utilizing local in-field trials to gain firsthand knowledge of the best product lines for the area. Let us help you with your seed selection decisions. Offering direct shipping or local seed delivery services for your seed needs. For additional information, call Shane at 785-299-0510. Mann Farms and AgriGold, proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Selensky Land and Cattle Inc. and Circle S Trucking of Park, Kansas proudly support all Bulldog activities and athletics. Curtis and Kelly, Lifelong residents of Gove County have been in the farming and cattle feeding business for over 30 years, proudly running their family business to this day. They operate a cattle feed yard and also grow wheat, corn, and livestock feed. Circle S Trucking, led by Carson Selinski, has been actively hauling needs of the local area for silage, grain, and manure for 2 years. Selinski Land and Cattle and Circle S Trucking would like to congratulate and support the Bulldogs for that successful year and wish them the best of luck.
Smoky Hill Ag is your precision ag service dealer. They offer customized agronomy for your farm, providing precision fertilizer applications with custom chemical blends. Smoky Hill Ag will create recommendations specific to each farmer's needs. With local service and competitive prices over the past 15 years, Smoky Hill Ag provides local ownership, management, and employment with community involvement. Trust them for all of your customized agronomy needs. Smoky Hill Ag, a loyal supporter of Quinter High School.
Wagner Manure Spreading LLC was established in 1997 with just two spreader trucks and one payloader. It has grown into a family-owned business in western Kansas. The Wagner family, with owners Greg and Yvonne, sons Toby, Tyler, Tanner, and their families, all specialize in the stockpiling and spreading of manure. They're also available for any of your hopper bottom needs, including grain, dry fertilizer, etc. If you need pens cleaned, we have plenty of payloader experience, as no job is too big or too small. So contact Wagner Manure Spreading LLC, proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
At Beck, we are farmers at heart. For over 100 years, the Beck family has lived and farmed in central Indiana. We are proud to announce Saline River Seed, your dedicated Beck's dealers now serving farmers in northwest Kansas. At Beck's, we are committed to helping farmers seek new challenges, push boundaries, and innovate in an ever-changing industry. That's what makes Beck's different. For more information, call your Beck's local dealer, Darren Roberts, at 785-299-0126.
Harmony Farms Kansas is a sixth-generation family farm located in Decatur County, Kansas. It was founded in 1878, and we still farm the original homestead. Harmony Farms Kansas has been certified organic since 1987, and we're certified by the Organic Crop Improvement Association, National Organic Producers, and in Canada, with the U.S.-Canadian Equivalency Program. Harmony Farms offers certified organic wheat, milo, and millet, both in bulk and individual packaging, along with individual bags of whole wheat flour. Harmony Farms Kansas, a proud supporter of Quinter Schools.
Family Market in downtown Quinter is here to provide fuel for Bulldogs of all ages. Come in and check out our variety of fresh produce, the large selection from the meat department, or food from the deli section. Offering weekly specials, Family Market has your family covered. Shop local, where we provide friendly smiles, a warm welcome, and service you can't find elsewhere. Family Market, a locally owned grocery store, is a proud supporter of all things Bulldog and Bulldog Athletics.
Kinder Sires Barnes is your Farm Bureau agent, serving the area since 2008. Give her team a call today to learn how they can make it easy to protect things that are most important to you, your home, family, farm, and future. Kinder's team is committed to offering quality products and exceptional service. If you have questions, they are just a phone call away. Kinder appreciates the opportunity to earn your business, and she and the team look forward to showing you how simple insurance can be.
GG&T Cattle Company is a fourth-generation seed stock producer owned and operated by Cindy, Garrett, Crystal, Reed, and Jessica Worth. They specialize in registered Slayers, Angus, and Optimizer cattle. Join GG&T for the 49th Annual Production Sale on February 22, 2024 at their ranch south of Quinter. GG&T Cattle Company, proud supporters of the Quinter Bulldogs.
Gove Community Bible Church, located in Gove, Kansas, is a Jesus-driven community that is proud to support the Quinter Bulldogs. We offer worship on Sunday mornings at 10:30 a.m. If you would like to know more about our church, visit our website at www.govecbc.com or download our Faith Life app from the QR code. Be sure to follow us on Facebook as well. Good luck, Bulldogs!
Gove County Medical Center is your 24-hour critical access hospital, located in Quinter, Kansas. Since 1925, GCMC has been providing outstanding health care to Northwest Kansas with services such as surgery, physical therapy, radiology, podiatry, orthopedics, lab, and much more. For the right care, at the right time, in the right place close to home, call 785-754-3341. GCMC is committed to others, always. Proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Kansas Land Bank is a locally owned community bank supporting community and school events. They are a full-service bank offering everything from ag loans to personal savings and checking accounts. Kansas Land Bank has a friendly staff that provides that personal touch. As one of the few locally owned community banks left in western Kansas, they strive to serve the needs of the people in our area. Kansas Land Bank remains a proud supporter of all Bulldog activities.
Mann Farms is your local AgriGold agent. For over 80 years, AgriGold has delivered quality corn and soybean seed to growers with unmatched genetic innovation and performance, utilizing local in-field trials to gain firsthand knowledge of the best product lines for the area. Let us help you with your seed selection decisions. Offering direct shipping or local seed delivery services for your seed needs. For additional information, call Shane at 785-299-0510. Mann Farms and AgriGold, proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Selensky Land and Cattle Inc. and Circle S Trucking of Park, Kansas proudly support all Bulldog activities and athletics. Curtis and Kelly, lifelong residents of Gove County, have been in the farming and cattle feeding business for over 30 years, proudly running their family business to this day. They operate a cattle feed yard and also grow wheat, corn, and livestock feed. Circle S Trucking, led by Carson Selensky, has been actively hauling needs of the local area for silage, grain, and manure for 2 years. Selensky Land and Cattle and Circle S Trucking would like to congratulate and support the Bulldogs for that successful year and wish them the best of luck.
Smoky Hill Ag is your precision ag service dealer. They offer customized agronomy for your farm, providing precision fertilizer applications with custom chemical blends. Smoky Hill Ag will create recommendations specific to each farmer's needs. With local service and competitive prices over the past 15 years, Smoky Hill Ag provides local ownership, management, and employment with community involvement. Trust them for all of your customized agronomy needs. Smoky Hill Ag, a loyal supporter of Quinter High School.
Wagner Manure Spreading LLC was established in 1997 with just 2 spreader trucks and 1 payloader. It has grown into a family-owned business in western Kansas. The Wagner family, with owners Greg and Yvonne, sons Toby, Tyler, Tanner, and their families, all specialize in the stockpiling and spreading of manure. They're also available for any of your hopper bottom needs, including grain, dry fertilizer, etc. If you need pins cleaned, we have plenty of payloader experience, as no job is too big or too small. So contact Wagner Manure Spreading LLC, proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
At Beck's, we are farmers at heart. For over 100 years, the Beck family has lived and farmed in central Indiana. We are proud to announce Saline River Seed, your dedicated Beck's dealers now serving farmers in northwest Kansas. At Beck's, we are committed to helping farmers seek new challenges, push boundaries, and innovate in an ever-changing industry. That's what makes Beck's different. For more information, call your Beck's local dealer, Darren Roberts, at 785-299-0126.
Harmony Farms Kansas is a 6th-generation family farm located in Decatur County, Kansas. It was founded in 1878, and we still farm the original homestead. Harmony Farms Kansas has been certified organic since 1987, and we're certified by the Organic Crop Improvement Association, National Organic Producers, and in Canada, with the U.S.-Canadian Equivalency Program. Harmony Farms offers certified organic wheat, milo, and millet, both in bulk and individual packaging, along with individual bags of whole wheat flour. Harmony Farms Kansas, a proud supporter of Quinter Schools.
Family Market in downtown Quinter is here to provide fuel for Bulldogs of all ages. Come in and check out our variety of fresh produce, the large selection from the meat department, or food from the deli section. Offering weekly specials, Family Market has your family covered. Shop local, where we provide friendly smiles, a warm welcome, and service you can't find elsewhere. Family Market, a locally owned grocery store, is a proud supporter of all things Bulldog and Bulldog athletics.
Kinder Sires Barnes is your Farm Bureau agent, serving the area since 2008. Give her team a call today to learn how they can make it easy to protect things that are most important to you, your home, family, farm, and future. Kinder's team is committed to offering quality products and exceptional service. If you have questions, they are just a phone call away. Kinder appreciates the opportunity to earn your business, and she and the team look forward to showing you how simple insurance can be.
GG&T Cattle Company is a fourth generation seed stock producer owned and operated by Cindy, Garrett, Crystal, Reed, and Jessica Worth. They specialize in registered Slayers, Angus, and Optimizer cattle. Join GG&T for the 49th annual production sale on February 22nd, 2024 at their ranch south of Quinter. GG&T Cattle Company, proud supporters of the Quinter Bulldogs.
Gove Community Bible Church, located in Gove, Kansas, is a Jesus-driven community that is proud to support the Quinter Bulldogs. We offer worship on Sunday mornings at 10:30 a.m. If you would like to know more about our church, visit our website at www.govecbc.com or download our Faith Life app from the QR code. Be sure to follow us on Facebook as well. Good luck, Bulldogs!
Gove County Medical Center is your 24-hour critical access hospital, located in Quinter, Kansas. Since 1925, GCMC has been providing outstanding health care to Northwest Kansas with services such as surgery, physical therapy, radiology, podiatry, orthopedics, lab, and much more. For the right care, at the right time, in the right place close to home, call 785-754-3341. GCMC is committed to others, always. Proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Quinter High School for the second round of the Rockwood Academy Tournament. Tonight's matchup, we have your Quinter Bulldogs versus Pawnee Heights. Quinter Bulldogs coming off a great 2-0 record, and the Pawnee Heights coming out 1-1. Tell us a little bit about Pawnee.
Yeah, Pawnee Heights, one loss on the season in this early season, a close one at that, losing by 4 to South Central on the road. Still a very tough team that the Bulldogs will be going up against here this afternoon in the second round of the Castle Rock Classic.
Very much so. We have a bunch of new girls, a bunch of luck to see tonight. Both teams had a really good win on Tuesday night, so let's see if they both bring the same energy tonight against each other. Worth takes it down the side. All the way across there. Kavinska takes a shot from three, misses. Rebounded by Selensky. Selensky hits it over the corner. Back to Kavinska. Little high on the pass over there to Worth, out of bounds. It'll be Pawnee Heights ball.
And the Bulldogs unable to get anything to go for him there. They had an open look beyond the arc and then running down, crashing towards the basket to get the offensive rebound. Just a little bit of miscommunication there on the pass, getting the turnover.
Yeah, so I had a little bit of press there, but the Pawnee Heights broke the press quite easy. He's going to move the ball around looking for a shot. Yeah, we can look at it. Hands drives in. Gives it to her sister. Puts it up for 2-0-2 here. We've got 7 minutes.
And Abby Hands down low, just using that mismatch on Kwasniska, getting that one to go.
Now, Quinter ball trying to look around for a shot, moving the ball. Rick takes it, gives it to the corner. Back over, long pass. Shot from three again from Kwasniska. Misses the rim. Worth saves the ball, but unfortunately, Pawnee Heights was able to retrieve it.
Now, Kwasniska 0-for-2 beyond the arc. Both pretty open looks. Just unable to convert on either one.
A little bit of mix up, and Bulldogs come out with the ball. Great steal there by Kwasniska. Shot from Worth in the corner. Over the rim a little hard. Both teams go for the rebound. Unfortunately, went out on the Bulldogs. So it'll be Pawnee Heights Tigers ball.
All three shots put up from the Bulldogs so far have been beyond the arc. None of them going for him. a team that really been struggling shooting the deep ball, just 4 for 20 coming into this matchup beyond the arc. And it's showing right now, unable to get really any of them to convert.
Betts there with the foul, trying to put that hard press on them, and wasn't able to get it and got called for it. It's pointing out inbounds the ball on their side of the court. Trying. Oh, yeah. This Presnison gets on the floor with Pawnee. Jump ball, so it'll now still be Pawnee Heights ball. Still hasn't crossed half court yet after the out of bounds. Finally gets across half court with hands. She takes it all the way up from the hoop and puts it in. Olivia Hands for two. As Quinter quickly brings the ball down the floor. So this would look like she had a shot, gave it away. And toss up in the middle, tipped by Pawnee. Worth came out on top of it. Presnison brings it back to the top, hoping to set something up. Over to Worth. Worth takes a three and drains it for 3-4 here now. Well, I was only down by one. Pawnee Heights breaks the press a little bit easier this time back down. Overhands it there. Tries, puts it inside to her sister. It's sealed by Worth. Worth bringing it down the line. Goes for a shot and gets it in for two.
Worth now leading the team in scores and the only one to score with five. Going off the fast break. We're going to see a lot of those fast break points from this fast Quinter defense.
They are fast. And now it looks like Pawnee Heights is trying to inbound the ball, threw it against the backboard. You got to know where that backboard's at when you're underneath. You're able to move around if they make the basket. So Quinter now trying to inbound the ball. Inbounds it to Worth. Worth looks like shot shots. Gives it to Glipsy. Glipsy over to Briggs. Briggs driving there. It looks like a foul called. Number 4, Faith Hamek. Serenity Smith inbounds the ball. Over to Briggs. Over to Zelensky. Zelensky over back over to Worth. Worth takes the three again. Drains another one. Great shooting by Worth now. 8-4 with 4:30 left.
The Bulldogs started off cold beyond the arc, 0-3, but since then 2-2, taking the lead.
Great defense by Serena Smith, getting a little push around, making her defender Olivia Hand step out of bounds, back to Quinter's side of the ball. Haven't seen really any forward court aggression from Pawnee Heights. Serena Smith was trying to get it across, but was affected there by Cordell Vadil. Weren't looking for another three, wasn't there. All the way down to Smith. Smith in the corner to Gillespie. That's his back at the top. It's Briggs. Briggs over to Worth. Worth to Smith. Smith's three. Rimmed out. Rebounded by Olivia Hands. She's a, for 6'3", she's going to get a lot of rebounds tonight. Hands gets to her sister down low. Other Hands. Stolen by Gillespie, excuse me. Gets the word. Word tried to up under the hoop and missed it. Rebounded by Pawnee. As when it was unable to set the press up. Timeout called by Pawnee Heights there, 30 seconds. So we'll take this time to thank some of the sponsors. Kendra Barnes at Farm Bureau Financial Services, here to help you protect what matters most in life. Kaiser Angus, certified Angus beef sellers and proud supporters for the Bulldogs. Swansea Land and Cattle Company, wishing the Bulldogs good luck during the 2023-2024 school year. Smoky Hill Ag, serving Lane, Logan, and Gov counties. We come back here. The Bulldogs now leading 8-4 with two great threes from Worth. Had a little bit contesting, but really just went straight in. So great shooting there as we take Pawnee's out of Pawnee's timeout on their side of the floor. And it looked to get it in. Finally gets it into Abby Hands. Hands looking for her sister. Gets it to her. Livia Hands up for another two.
All six points for Pawnee Heights coming from down low. Really taking advantage of that height down low.
Very much so. Both sisters, I believe, as well. There's work tries going in there for a layup. Was blocked but fouled on Abby Hands there. Her first foul, her team's second. First one rims out for Worth. As Abby Pelton comes in for Beside. And Work gets the second one. 9-6 here with 3:15 left. As Olivia Hands brings the ball down the floor. Gives her sister in the corner. It looks like Abby wanted to take a shot. But throws the ball over her teammate, is rushing down the floor and goes out of bounds. Bulldogs ball on their side of the floor. As Kuzniska comes in for Worth. They're having a great game, making a free throw and a couple threes.
Yeah, all 9 points actually coming from Worth. As she steps onto the bench now.
Kuzniska tried a three there. Was broken out. Rebounded by Glipsy, but unfortunately was thrown away. Pawnee brings it down the ball. Olivia Hands gets it again. Gets it to her sister Abby. Abby goes up, misses the shot, but is fouled. And she's now going to shoot for two.
And Pawnee Heights continuing to just eat down low. Not getting the basket there, but able to draw the foul and take some trips to the line.
Yeah, you got two tall sisters there. Her Olivia Hands, 6'3", Abby Hands, 6'. As Abby Hands drains the first one. And rims out the back and that can rebound by Smith. Smith drives down the floor. Tried to get it in there to Briggs, but was blocked. Unfortunately, she got it back. Max Smith is going to take a shot for a three. Rims out. Fight for the ball. And it looks like it went off Abby Hands. And it's going to give the Quinter Bulldogs ball on their side of the floor.
Yeah, and just great effort there from Mia Briggs. Running out and then throwing it back in off of Hands. So then it rolls off out of Hands.
Didn't work with her. Kuzniska gets back to Smith. Smith's bringing runs coming. Kuzniska's going to take a three. Little too hard on it, but rebounded by Briggs. Great offensive rebounds there. Gets it in. Glips is looking to get a shot. Wasn't there. Kicks it back out. Linda Briggs in the corner. Briggs looking to drive, but accidentally jumped too early and got a travel called. So the Nami Tigers ball bringing it back down. Great defense by Pawnee there. Olivia Hands looking to get it back to her teammate, but unfortunately was intercepted by Selensky for up for two. Smith with great defense there, forcing Beside Ibarra to drop the ball off a foot and go out of bounds for another Quinter ball. As number four, Faith Huckman comes back in for Pawnee Heights and sits Olivia Hands. Briggs is dribbling around the top, looking for something open. Finally finds Glipsy. Glipsy gets it over to Briggs. Briggs in the corner to Smith. Smith all the way across Zinsy. Glipsy in the corner now with it. Bulldogs is doing some long passes here, trying to see what they can get. Glipsy drives, tries to put it up. No foul call and a miss. Tries to get a ball back from Abby Hand, but unfortunately she gets it out. And a steal from Smith. Smith gets a miss. And she goes up for, just a little underneath.
And right now the Bulldogs, they're getting the steals. They're just struggling to convert on those fast breaks. Like we saw last matchup Tuesday, they were able to really convert on all those, but here, really struggling to get them go.
Yeah, a little bit there. She was a little bit uneasy there as well. As Olivia Hands comes back in for Pawnee Heights. But Smith is going to take the ball up top. Gives it to Kwiniska. Kwiniska for her three. Grits it in there. 14-7 with 52 seconds left in the first quarter. The press really starting to get to these Pawnee Heights as Olivia Hands turns the ball over. And that's what these Quinter Bulldogs really want, is those turnovers right there. As Lips gets into the three, as soon as he gets it, lights it up. Of course, rims out, rebounded by number four, Faith Hockney, as their point guard, Jocelyn, brings it down the floor. A little bit of trouble. Living Hands comes out, drives, lays it in there right above everybody for two.
Yeah, and right now, all the points for Pawnee Heights, except for one free throw, have came from inside the paint.
Very much so. Some little miscommunication. Missed shot there by Quinter. He's not able to rebound. Ooh. Looks like Cordell Valiz was trying to go up for a drive there and was slapped pretty good there. And she's still sitting on the floor now as she gets helped up. That was on Galipsy there.
Yeah, and from up here, it did sound like a little bit of a slap.
A little bit of rough. She's still trying to recover. It might have landed on her knee there. It looks like she's trying to create home up. Still going to take her free throws. Gets it in the first one. As number 22, Sharon Ballman, comes in for number 12. Selensky for Bulldogs. And there's her second one. Great free throw shooting there by Pawnee. Galipsy looks for a shot, wasn't there. Drives, two steps, and banks it in for number two. Big work drive by Galipsy. And that's the first quarter here. Great work by both teams. Bulldogs leading 16-11 as we go here into the second quarter. We'll be right back.
Kansas Land Bank is a locally owned community bank supporting community and school events. They are a full-service bank offering everything from ag loans to personal savings and checking accounts. Kansas Land Bank has a friendly staff that provides that personal touch. As one of the few locally owned community banks left in Western Kansas, they strive to serve the needs of the people in our area. Kansas Land Bank remains a proud supporter of all Bulldog activities.
Mann Farms is your local AgriGold agent. For over 80 years, AgriGold has delivered quality corn and soybean seed to growers with unmatched genetic innovation and performance, utilizing local in-field trials to gain firsthand knowledge of the best product lines for the area. Let us help you with your seed selection decisions. Offering direct shipping or local seed delivery services for your seed needs. For additional information, call Shane at 785-299-0510. Mann Farms and AgriGold, proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, as we enter the second quarter for the Pawnee Heights, hosted by the Quinter Bulldogs. Bulldogs leading 16-11, having a lot of turnovers, forcing a lot of turnovers on those Pawnee Heights. We'll definitely see a lot more press from them most of this game if they could keep it close. Pawnee's ball as we come back here. This is the start of the half. Moving on, gets it to Living Hands. Living Hands tries to get it back out to Arista. Back up top to Cordell. She drives. Looking for a shot, no foul call, but lost the ball. Saved as well, but recovered by Betts. Betts pushing down the ball to Glimpy. Over to Wirth. Wirth gives it to Havensky. Got it, 3-3. 19-11.
Great ball movement from the Bulldogs. And then Kennedy Wirth snatching that one, saving it from going out of bounds, and then quickly getting it to Kwasniska.
Like you said, another foul on Cordell Valiz. She's trying to get a pass, got a little hand in there from Shaylee Ballman. It's her first one. Ball logs inbound to the point guard Cordell Valiz. Turns it around to Barista. Barista gets inside, tried to get it out of hands, but there was Ballin right there to save it. Gives it to Gulitsky. She drives it down all the way. Had a little short, but gets a rebound out to where it worked with a three, little long. Rebounded. Went out of bounds on. Looks like the Bulldogs. It looks like Kwasinska tried to get the rebound, was unfortunate to put it back behind her. Dropped down on her side.
Yeah, Kwasinska, she doesn't get that one back in, but the Bulldogs, you got to give them a lot of credit for really all of the first quarter and still here in the second quarter, grabbing those offensive rebounds and then hustling to save them, keeping it in play.
Exactly right, taking all those shots. As now, Addie Pelton tries for a three, was short, rebounded by Abby. Hands, missed as well. That one rebounded by Betts. Now we're bringing it back down the ball. Let's go up. He gets it over to Kwasniewska. Kwasniewski across to Betts. Betts for her three. Misses the rim. As two Bulldogs try to go get the rebound, but unfortunately wasn't fast enough.
That three ball from Betts, I believe it was tipped from Maddie Pelton. Just good defense there from the Pawnee Heights Tigers.
Addie Hargett comes in for the Bulldogs, hoping to give them a little bit of a break and help. Pawnee Heights finally getting it into Olivia Hands with a great press by Quinter. Foul on Kwasniewska there, a little push there. It looks like it was pushing Berliska, trying to get to the ball to defend. It's her second one of the night here in the second quarter. 6:22. Pawnee gets it in without troubles. Brissa takes it around, gets it up to Hawkman. Hawkman down over to Pelton. Pelton drives, shoots it from the court elbow and misses it. Rebounded by Wirth. Wirth drives down the floor. Olivia Hands attempted to play a little defense. Got a little arm in there too far, so that's going to be a foul on her. Her first one of the night. Kwasniewska comes out and Serenity Smith comes in for her. Kwasniewska gets into the Worth and Hedge. Hargett in the top. This is back to the top to Worth. Worth with her three. A little short. Rebounded by Worth in the corner. And then Betts is going to take her three. Long. And the Bulldogs go and rebound it again on the other side of the court. Trying a little bit off balance, loses the ball, and is picked up by Hammaken. As Olivia Hikes tries to get around the floor. Looks like a little bit too far reach there by Worth. Her first one of the night. Team is at three this quarter. As Salenzi comes in for the Bulldogs. Olivia Hands gets this to Abby Hands. Trying to go up for the shot. They're going to say she was on the ground. So they'll take it under the hoop. Fouled by Sage Betts there. Her second one of the night. Team fourth. Gets it to Abby Hands. Falling out of the into bounds. Gets it up to Hawkman. Hawkman goes a little wrong. Rebounded by Pelton. Pelton goes up. Misses it. Looks like Abby Hands down there. Excuse me. Olivia Hands down there is trying to fight for the ball. With a couple Bulldogs able to make it a jump ball.
Yeah, the Bulldogs defense is doing a good job of collapsing down on that and getting hands all over. And able to force the jump ball.
And Glips becomes in for Betts. As the Bulldogs Worth takes it down. Just moves to the top, gets to the corner to Worth. Worth thought about shooting, backs off. Goes drives, little floater, short. Rebounded there by Ibarra. And Cordova Valise brings it down the floor once again. Hockman goes up for a little floater, misses. Rebounded by Olivia Hands. Puts it in there for two. 19-13 here. Smith tried to get it in there So Zielinski wasn't able to get anything off. Hockman in the right, looking for something to help him drive. Still some taking a short shot, runs in and out. Rebounded though for the point guard Cordo Valdez and gets the shooting foul.
And right there, Bryn Gillespie had the size advantage on Cordeo Valdez. Just Valdez does a good job drawing that foul against that size disadvantage.
Gillespie, her second foul, team's fifth. As Rosalie misses her first one. This is her second one as well. Abby Hans tried to get in there for the rebound. It looks like Zielinski was running in to get the ball and unfortunately stepped out of bounds. So it's going to be Pawnee Heights ball right next to their basket. Finally gets it in. Cordero Valdez gets it out to Abby. Looking at Hans for a nice little floater there. It's a 19-15 here with 4:02 left in the half.
Yeah, Hans just popping out, having a defender down low, but then popping out, leaves her open, and nice floater, like you said.
Very tall, using the size advantage. Looks like Hargett with the three, gets it in for three. 22-15 now. As Bulldogs keep up the press. And gets an offensive. It's going to be on Cordell Valdez. Extended her arm, it looks like she says, as number two, Sage Betts for Bulldogs, comes in for Serenity Smith. She's trying to create a little room there. Unfortunately, just had too much contact. Betts gets it. Gets it over to Briggs. Briggs into the corner to Gillespie. Hargett comes up top of it. Drive from Mia Briggs. Rims out. Jump ball there on the rebound. It will be Pawnee Heights Tigers ball.
And that Bulldog possession, good in and out ball movement, and then getting outside to Mia Briggs. Cutting down, had a good look. That one just unfortunately rolling in and out of the basket.
See a few of those tonight as Pawnee tries to get it back in. Finally gets it to their tall girl Olivia Hands. She's met by three Bulldogs. Finally gets it to Cordero Valdez. Gets it into Briesta. It was stopped as she saves the rebound, but unfortunately was grabbed by Betts. Kwasniska with her three, a little bit short, comes up with it. Fight for the rebound, and a foul called on the Bulldogs. Looks like his call was called on Betts, as now we shoot 1-1. The shooter, Barista Herbera. First one a little long, bounces out to the right as Worth comes in for Betts. Another one, second one a little long, rebounded by Lifty. She brings down the floor. She's Briggs, Briggs goes up for two. Great pass there by Lifty to Briggs. Now their press is put on as Pawnee Heights stolen by Worth. Worth gets it in to Zielinski. Zielinski puts it up for two. 26-15 with 2:30 left.
And Worth just doing an excellent job of reading that pass on the inbound, jumping in front of it.
As Kwasniska tries to do the exact same thing, but unfortunately gets called for a foul. We go down to another one. That's her third in this game. Let's see her take a break here.
Right now, Pawnee Heights, they're going to need to convert on these. They're in that bonus right now. These free throws are going to be crucial, trailing by 10.
As much as Olivia Heights goes to take her first one. Hands puts in her first, makes it 26-16. As Ballman comes in for Kwasniewska. Second one's good as well. We got Wirt bringing the ball down for the Bulldogs. Wirt gets it to Zielinski. Glitz, he takes a three. It drains it. Had a little bit of a contact. Nothing called. Makes it 29-17 here as the Pawnee Heights gets it down. They take a three from Pelton. Short. And it looks like Zielinski had a push there on Olivia Hands. She's going to go shoot two free throws now.
Now these fouls, these free throw trips are really what's going to allow for Pawnee Heights to stay in this one. Quinter, opportunity to crawl away with it now. But if Pawnee Heights continues to get trips, free trips to the free throw line, that's going to keep them right in it.
Yep, sometimes you need that with the putting on that press. It's kind of hard to break. But she makes the first one there. Ooh, a little bit too right on her second one. As Briggs rebounds it, brings down the floor. Little trip up. Kane's ball gets the worst. To Zielinski. Cross four to Golipski. She drives, takes a little floater. A little too long. Another fight for the ball and ends up on another jump ball. Gonna be Bulldogs. Bulldogs ball here under their home basket. Zielinski finally gets it to Golipski. She drives, goes for another shot. Blocked by Olivia Hands. But it went out of bounds. Still Bulldogs ball, but great block there on for Olivia as the timeout's called. Full timeout. So we'll take another chance here to thank some of the sponsors here for Quinter Bulldogs. Gove County Medical Center, your comprehensive health care provider in Northwest Kansas. Healing through caring, Gove County Medical Center. Kansas Land Bank, Western Kansas' favorite bank, Kansas Land Bank. Family Market, your hometown grocery, Go Big Red. GG&T Cattle Company, the Worth family is a proud supporter of the Quinter Bulldogs. Aragog Seed and Man Farms, helping feed the Quinter Bulldogs and the world. Gov Community Bible Church, a Jesus-driven community. We support the Quinter Bulldogs. Cerline River Seed, contact Darren Roberts, your Beck Area Seed Dealers, farmers and Bulldog fans at heart. And Wagner Manure Spreading, proud supporters of the Quinter Bulldogs and thrilled to help spreading Bulldog pride. Come back here, 29-18, Bulldogs lead with their ball back underneath the basket. Pawnee Heights putting up a lot better fight than what we saw Bulldogs play Tuesday night. So let's hope they can keep some energy going here through the rest of the half. Gillespie trying to gets it to Zielinski. Zielinski gets it to Briggs. Briggs drives high, rips it off, rebounded by Olivia Hands. Stealing by Worth. Unfortunately, he steps out of bounds on it. We're seeing that speed tonight from the Bulldogs.
And all of that, Bulldogs not going to get the steal as that one goes out of bounds, but that's just what they have shown all season and continuing right now in this first half is just that speed and quick hands and feet getting to the ball.
Definitely. You definitely see it on their way getting back on their press. Stealing in, Michael Esty grabbed by Zielinski. Zielinski gets it into Briggs with a little contact, but she puts it out without any contact. Another 2 points here, 31-18 as the Bulldogs start to pull away here with about 60 seconds left in the half. Zabby Hands looks for Hockman. Hockman drives, gets it to Pelton. Pelton, unfortunately, gives a jump ball. It'll be Tigers ball underneath their own hoop. gets in, tries getting it to Olivia Hands, but it was blocked there by a Bulldog.
And the Bulldogs just corralling down on Hands down low, not allowing much room for her to work with.
Indeed, as Worth there tries to take a shot, was unable to miss. So Pawnee now brings the ball down the floor. Tried to get it to Abby Hands, but was stolen by Mia Briggs, and she gets it to Zielinski. Zielinski puts it up for another two. 31-18 with 22 seconds left. Abby Hands now looking for something. That's not helping her much. Gets into her sister, Livy Hands. Livy Hands puts it up. Puts it in for an N1 there.
Olivia Hands has had herself a night. She's also been an excellent free throw shooter as well, getting herself a trip to the line again.
She's been doing quite well, only missing a few free throws, maybe one on the night. Let's see if she continues that streak going, because that's what they're going to need. As she makes it a three-point play, making it 33-21 with 10 seconds left. We have to discuss if the sub was there before the ball was inbounded. A little bit of confusion on Pawnee's height. They're discussing if the sub was there in time by the ball was inbounded. And it looks like they're going to allow it. In comes Barista Rivera for Pawnee Heights. Now Worth bringing the ball down for the Bulldogs with 10 seconds left to go. It looks like Valiz was trying to stop the ball there. Tipped it out of bounds. Still Bulldogs ball. That's the word. Over to Briggs. Briggs drives. No contact. Gets a shot to get shut off, but nothing called as Olivia Hands gets the ball as we go here into halftime. Bulldogs up 33-21 here as we take it here in the next half.
Zielinski Land and Cattle Inc. and Circle S Trucking of Park, Kansas proudly support all Bulldog activities and athletics. Curtis and Kelly, lifelong residents of Gove County, have been in the farming and cattle feeding business for over 30 years, proudly running their family business to this day. They operate a cattle feed yard and also grow wheat, corn, and livestock feed. Circle S Trucking, led by Carson Zielinski, has been actively hauling needs of the local area for silage, grain, and manure for 2 years. Zielinski Land and Cattle and Circle S Trucking would like to congratulate and support the Bulldogs throughout the successful year and wish them the best of luck.
Smoky Hill Ag is your precision ag service dealer. They offer customized agronomy for your farm, providing precision fertilizer applications with custom chemical blends. Smoky Hill Ag will create recommendations specific to each farmer's needs. With local service and competitive prices over the past 15 years, Smoky Hill Ag provides local ownership, management, and employment with community involvement. Trust them for all of your customized agronomy needs. Smoky Hill Ag, a loyal supporter of Quinter High School.
Wagner Manure Spreading LLC was established in 1997 with just two spreader trucks and one payloader. It has grown into a family-owned business in western Kansas. The Wagner family, with owners Greg and Yvonne, sons Toby, Tyler, Tanner, and their families, all specialize in the stockpiling and spreading of manure. They're also available for any of your hopper bottom needs, including grain, dry fertilizer, etc. If you need pens cleaned, we have plenty of payloader experience, as no job is too big or too small. So contact Wagner Manure Spreading LLC, proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
At Beck's, we are farmers at heart. For over 100 years, the Beck family has lived and farmed in central Indiana. We are proud to announce Saline River Seed, your dedicated Beck's dealers now serving farmers in northwest Kansas. At Beck's, we are committed to helping farmers seek new challenges, push boundaries, and innovate in an ever-changing industry. That's what makes Beck's different. For more information, call your Beck's local dealer, Darren Roberts, at 785-299-0126.
Harmony Farms Kansas is a sixth-generation family farm located in Decatur County, Kansas. It was founded in 1878, and we still farm the original homestead. Harmony Farms Kansas has been certified organic since 1987, and we're certified by the Organic Crop Improvement Association, National Organic Producers, and in Canada, with the U.S.-Canadian Equivalency Program. Harmony Farms offers certified organic wheat, milo, and millet, both in bulk, and individual packaging along with individual bags of whole wheat flour. Harmony Farms Kansas, a proud supporter of Quinter Schools.
Family Market in downtown Quinter is here to provide fuel for bulldogs of all ages. Come in and check out our variety of fresh produce, the large selection from the meat department, or food from the deli section. Offering weekly specials, Family Market has your family covered. Shop local, where we provide friendly smiles, a warm welcome, and service you can't find elsewhere. Family Market, a locally owned grocery store, is a proud supporter of all things Bulldog and Bulldog Athletics.
Quinter Sires Barnes is your Farm Bureau agent, serving the area since 2008. Give her team a call today to learn how they can make it easy to protect things that are most important to you, your home, family, farm, and future. Kinder's team is committed to offering quality products and exceptional service. If you have questions, they are just a phone call away. Kinder appreciates the opportunity to earn your business, and she and the team look forward to showing you how simple insurance can be.
GG&T Cattle Company is a fourth generation seed stock producer owned and operated by Cindy, Garrett, Crystal, Reed, and Jessica Worth. They specialize in registered Slayers, Angus, and Optimizer cattle. Join GG&T for the 49th annual production sale on February 22nd, 2024 at their ranch south of Quinter. GG&T Cattle Company, proud supporters of the Quinter Bulldogs.
Gove Community Bible Church, located in Gove, Kansas, is a Jesus-driven community that is proud to support the Quinter Bulldogs. We offer worship on Sunday mornings at 10:30 a.m. If you would like to know more about our church, visit our website at www.govecbc.com or download our Faith Life app from the QR code. Be sure to follow us on Facebook as well. Good luck, Bulldogs!
Gove County Medical Center is your 24-hour critical access hospital, located in Quinter, Kansas. Since 1925, GCMC has been providing outstanding health care to Northwest Kansas with services such as surgery, physical therapy, radiology, podiatry, orthopedics, lab, and much more. For the right care, at the right time, in the right place close to home, call 785-754-3341. GCMC is committed to others, always. Proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Kansas Land Bank is a locally owned community bank supporting community and school events. They are a full-service bank offering everything from ag loans to personal savings and checking accounts. Kansas Land Bank has a friendly staff that provides that personal touch. As one of the few locally owned community banks left in western Kansas, they strive to serve the needs of the people in our area. Kansas Land Bank remains a proud supporter of all Bulldog activities.
Mann Farms is your local AgriGold agent. For over 80 years, AgriGold has delivered quality corn and soybean seed to growers with unmatched genetic innovation and performance, utilizing local in-field trials to gain firsthand knowledge of the best product lines for the area. Let us help you with your seed selection decisions. Offering direct shipping or local seed delivery services for your seed needs. For additional information, call Shane at 785-299-0510. Mann Farms and AgriGold, proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Selensky Land and Cattle Inc. and Circle S Trucking of Park, Kansas proudly support all Bulldog activities and athletics. Curtis and Kelly, lifelong residents of Gove County, have been in the farming and cattle feeding business for over 30 years, proudly running their family business to this day. They operate a cattle feed yard and also grow wheat, corn, and livestock feed. Circle S Trucking, led by Carson Selensky, has been actively hauling needs of the local area for silage, grain, and manure for 2 years. Selensky Land and Cattle and Circle S Trucking would like to congratulate and support the Bulldogs for that successful year and wish them the best of luck.
Smoky Hill Ag is your precision ag service dealer. They offer customized agronomy for your farm, providing precision fertilizer applications with custom chemical blends. Smoky Hill Ag will create recommendations specific to each farmer's needs. With local service and competitive prices over the past 15 years, Smoky Hill Ag provides local ownership, management, and employment with community involvement. Trust them for all of your customized agronomy needs. Smoky Hill Ag, a loyal supporter of Quinter High School.
Wagner Manure Spreading LLC was established in 1997 with just two spreader trucks and one payloader. It has grown into a family-owned business in western Kansas. The Wagner family, with owners Greg and Yvonne, sons Toby, Tyler, Tanner, and their families, all specialize in the stockpiling and spreading of manure. They're also available for any of your hopper bottom needs, including grain, dry fertilizer, etc. If you need pens cleaned, we have plenty of payloader experience, as no job is too big or too small. So contact Wagner Manure Spreading LLC, proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, back to Quinter Bulldogs High School. The Bulldogs are hosting Pawnee Heights in the Castle Rock Tournament here. If you come back here, the Bulldogs are leading 33-21 over the Pawnee Heights Tigers. Dale, could you tell me, like, what the Pawnee Heights are doing wrong, what they're doing pretty good?
Yeah, the Pawnee Heights, is just tough to score against this Bulldogs team. It's very fast and aggressive, and they don't really allow for many good looks. But Pawnee Heights has seen some success down low in the paint between the two Hand sisters, Olivia Hands and Abby Hands. I'd like to see them go try to get back to that a little bit in rhythm, feeding it down low.
A lot of young players on Pawnee Heights as well. Kind of 9 freshmen, 2 sophomores, and 3 seniors. Some freshmen and seniors. Hammock, Pelton, there's a couple freshmen there. But over for Bulldogs, doing really good on their press as they normally do, making them turn over the ball, getting the steals where they need it, and putting up a few threes earlier in the half.
Yeah, this Bulldogs press, it's going to lead to a lot of steals. And even if the Bulldogs don't get a steal on it, a lot of the times the offense will come down, and then they're out of rhythm, and they're rushing to get a shot up, and they typically put up a bad shot is what we've seen from breaking through that press.
Yeah, definitely very hard to get over the speed. Almost every girl we've seen go in here for the Bulldogs, and that's what you need. Your bench to come in there and help you speed and just work as a team as well. Well, let's see what Pawnee Heights can do about that press as we enter here in the second half. Only trailing by 12 here, so not too far behind. We've got 2 more quarters inside.
You know, now Pawnee Heights are on pace to put up the most points against Quinter all season in the 2 matchups. The Bulldogs have not given up more than 30 points. And right now, Pawnee Heights on pace to get over 30.
As we hear, as Bulldogs are going to start the half with the ball. Because Nisk can bring the ball down 4. Bulldog, she had 3 fouls there in the first half. Taken out and didn't secure quite a lot here in the second quarter. Let's get back over to Worth. Worth's long skip pass over there to Betts. Betts looked to shoot, wasn't there. Selensky over to Kwasniska. Kwasniska Worth. Worth's going to take her chance. Little off. Rebounded by Gillespie. No good on a shot, but will get the shooting foul to start off here in the first 30 seconds.
And the Bulldogs really just slinging the ball around, some dangerous passes, but they're able to convert on them, helping getting some open looks and then getting down low.
Actually, especially with that height from Pawnee, 6'3" from Olivia Hands, and Abby Hands being 6' from her sisters. Tall family there, but Melissa makes her first free throw. Along with her second free throw there. Great shooting there from the line. Attempted steal there by Selensky. Fortunately, was hit it out of bounds and she herself went into the bleachers. She's all right. Pawnee still looking to get it in here. Back out stolen it from Worth. Navalis gets it over to Olivia Hands. Olivia Hands taking in the slice floater off the backboard in for 2. 25-23 here. As Worth drives into the paint and kicks it back out. Kwasniska gets it in. Selensky takes a little floater. A little short. It's like Worth tried to get in there, but Olivia Hands pulls it away for Pawnee. As Cordero Valles takes it down for Pawnee. Gets it into Abby Hands. Abby Hands gets to her sister, Olivia Hands. She puts it up off the backboard short. Rebounded by Gillespie. She takes it down the floor. Cruz at speed, looking to go all the way. Went up, missed a foul. Looks like got hit there in the face, but gets the shooting foul there. That one's going to be on their point guard, Cordero Valles. Her second one of the night, team second. First one rings out there for Gillespie. And Shorts, the first one, rebounded by Betts. Bulldogs are going to move the ball around once again. Long pass over to Kuzniska. She does the same to Selensky. Selensky takes it from the corner. Misses as Olivia Hands rebounds it, and the foul call on 11 Worth on the Bulldogs. Her third one of the night. Pawnee now going to try to get it in against that tough press. Finally gets it in there to Cordelia Valise. This is a fight for the ball between Selensky and point guard. She gets it out, but unfortunately for them, Olivia Hands gets the ball. As miscommunication, a little bit of chaos leads to Selensky accidentally falling over Cordelia Valise and causing her a foul, her second one.
Now Selensky just hustling for the ball, and then her momentum carrying her forward into Cordero Valdez for the foul.
So Pawnee still trying to get across that half court. Gets it to Olivia Hands. Nothing between the hoop and her. As she puts it in for two off the backboard. A little bit of contact. Nothing called, though. So Worth will bring it down. Bulldogs with that speed as usual. Worth takes a shot from the three. A little long. Rebounded by Kozniska. Gets it back out to Worth. She's going to get to Gillespie. Literally fakes a shot. Over to Kozniska. Gives it to Worth. Worth looking for something. Drives. Little floater. Little far. Rebounded by number four, Hammack, one of their freshmen there. Foul called on the Bulldogs. And he called on Betts, her fourth one of the night. As we see her and Kozniska go take a break as Smith and Braves comes in for them. Hands gets it, but just trapped in the corner. Loses the dribble as well. Gets it to her sister. Sister gets tipped by Worth. And as Abby tried grabbing it, wasn't able to bounce out of bounds. So it's going to be Bulldog ball here.
Just excellent hustle from Kennedy. Worth just running up behind. And Hands unexpecting it and tipping it out behind.
Definitely Abby Hands doesn't have the best handle. She's trying to get it to somebody who can get it down the floor for her. So the Bulldogs now just move the ball around. As Gillespie takes a long three, shoots it long. As Worth gets the rebound, though. Gillespie fakes the shot, drives off the backboard, bounces out. Rebounded by Hammack. Gives it to Cordero Valdez. She drives down the floor with two Bulldogs in her way. Still by Gillespie. She goes up. No one between her and the hoop. And puts it in for two with the shooting foul.
Let's be able to convert on that one, but got to go back to that steal. Just read Cordero Valdez. Excellent. Saw her turn it around and comes behind her where she couldn't see it and takes that one right away.
Yep. Good work by her. She got a little close there on the shot there, and the ref called her for just a little bit too much contact. But this makes her shot, making a three-point play. Zabby Hands now dribbles down the floor, no one between her and the hoop. A little bit of contact, but unfortunately breaks it off the rim. Selensky, looks like Bridges trying to get there to Selensky. Selensky couldn't hold on to it under the hoop. It'll be Pawnee's ball going back the other way. 38-25 with 4:53 left here. Pawnee looking to get it in. Finally gets it to the but bounces off her hands and out of bounds. She's going back to the Bulldogs ball. The Bulldogs now going to inbound it. Gillespie just gets in the corner. Worth is going to take it up to the top. Selensky in her opposite corner. Worth gets it inside to Briggs. Briggs off the backboard, but misses. Rebounded by Olivia Hands. Olivia Hands bringing it down the floor now. Gets it over to the Hammack. The Hammack gets it over to Barra. Barra gets it to Abby Hands. Goes up and blocked by Gillespie. As now Worth drives in and gets it in for a floater for two. 40-25 here. Teamed by Worth and gets by Brandt, Briggs. Briggs gets into Selensky. She misses. Kwasniewski rebounds it, and she misses. Rebounded by Selensky, and there was a foul called on the ground.
And Pawnee Heights, they have that size advantage down low, but the Bulldogs, they're really just crashing down toward the basket, out-rebounding it, and especially on the offensive side.
Excuse me, there's not a one for Pawnee Heights as the board asked, but there is a timeout called on the floor for Quinter and Pawnee. So we're going to give off some more of the sponsors real quick. Kendra Barnes at Farm Bureau Financial Services, here to help you protect what matters most in life. Razor Angus, certified Angus beef sellers and proud supporters of the Bulldogs. So that's the Land and Cattle Company, wishing the Bulldogs the best. Good luck during the 2023-2024 school year. Smoky Hill Ag, serving Lane, Logan, and Gov counties. To come back here, Jeff's still trying to figure out who the foul called on Pawnee, since there's not a one on their roster. Bulldogs still trying to pull away, still have a pretty good lead here over the Tigers as they can kind of continue their lead here and going to the third.
And I know the Bulldogs really starting to pull away, like you said, and a lot of that from that fast break that's starting to work in their favor. Earlier in the first half, they had quite a few steals, just struggling to convert on those shots, but now we've seen them get those steals and then converting on the shots.
Still some questions there from the booth. Sender's on number two. So it looks like they couldn't remember who the foul was on, but it's going to be Bulldogs ball underneath. As Gillespie goes up for a shot, but blocked by Olivia Hands. She now is going to take down the floor, but gets called for a carry, trying to spin away from those Bulldogs coming from behind her. As Worth goes out, and Hargett, comes in for the Bulldogs. Also, Ballman comes in. Ballman underneath the hoop, tries to get it to Hargett, but was unable to. Taken by Ibarra. It's taken back by Hargett, and she puts it in for two. Pawnee's still struggling, trying to get past this press. Gets it to Hammock. Hammock looking for someone. Gets it to Abby Hands. Abby Hands getting it back up to the point guard for Dio Valise. Valise swinging it to Olivia Hands. With her hands, tried getting into a barrel, but bounced off of her and was able to pick up by Ballman. Ballman goes all the way. Nope, gives it to Wozniska. She lays it up for two. Hands to hand. As Abby tries going down, but stolen by Serenity Smith. Gets it into Briggs underneath the hoop. She drives, kicks it back out to Harker. Hart with a floater, short. And rebounded by Abby Hands.
Hargett got away from the defense there, had a really nice open look. You just got to convert on those ones.
Indeed. Hands gets it over to her sister, Abby. Abby drives, shoots a little short, a little long. Rebounded by Ballman. She brings it down the floor. Ballman sees Serenity underneath the hoop, gets it in for two. Makes it 46-25 here with 2:30 left in the quarter. Maybe gets it back to her sister, Abby. Abby tries driving. Gives it back. Almost went out of bounds there to Olivia. Olivia tried getting it back to Abby, but picked up by Hargett. As Hargett drives down there, gives it the brig underneath, loses it, and picks up by Olivia Hands.
Just a careless pass there from Hargett to Briggs. She would have settled down and then looked at her options, would have been able to decipher a better option to go with.
Cordelia Valise picked up a dribbler, picked off by Briggs. Briggs lays it up for an easy 2 points there. Gotta keep your dribble alive as long as you can until you know you got a pass. As Pawnee tries to get it, as Abby's trying to drive it down. Using her big size, kicks it back out to Cordelia Valise. She's looking for someone open. Drives to the right. Gets to Abby on the opposite side. She goes up and puts it, banks it in for two. Hargan will bring down the floor for the Bulldogs. Smith looked like she wanted to shoot, but pulled back. Gets it in to Ballman. Ballman, little floater fade, misses it. Rebounded by Abby Hand. Scudero, Valiz brings it down the floor. Libby Hand looked to drive, kicks it back out to Hammock. Hammock to Obera. Barrick up, back up to Camaro. Cordero. She drives, tries getting it up for a shot. Gets the foul call finally. Been a while since we've seen Pawnee go to the line. She finally gets it here at the end of the third. Foul's going to be called on Ballman, her second one of the night. Gets it in there. As 11, Pelton's going to come in for number 22, Rivera, for the Pawnee Heights Tigers. Gets the second one in there. Great shooting there by Cordillo Valiz. So Hargan now throws it into Spencer Smith. She drives. It's going to be met underneath the hoop. It looks like a foul call on Pawnee Heights. Number four, Hammock. And your second one of the night. So she now shoots for two. And that was a little long. Both teams in bonus now. 5-5. Little off on the second one, rebounded by Olivia. It looks like Hargett held into her. A little wrong. It's going to be a foul call on Bulldogs. It's going to be. Now, Olivia Hands is going to be shooting her two free throws on that rebound. It's going to be her Hargett's first one of the night. May puts it in. Olivia Hands doing quite well on her free throw shooting. As four Bulldogs come in for Quinter here. Looks like the only one that stays on the floor was Worth. She misses her second one. Rebound in by Pelton, the freshman. Get it over Cordero Valiz. Gets it in Abby Hands. Abby Hands puts it up. Oh, a little too hard. Rebounded by Olivia Hands. Saves her sister, puts it in for two. 35 seconds left to go in the third quarter. As Gillespie try going, gets the call charge. Great defense there by Abby Hands, standing her ground. It's going to be her third one of the night. Looks like number 13, Sissel comes in for the point guard, Cordillo Valiz. Finally gets into Abby Hands. Abby Hands gets it to Hammock. Hammock trying to get back down. Gives it to Abby. She finally moves across half court. Hammock takes it to the top. Gets it over to Sissel. So Pelton's going to drive and puts it in as it rolls in there for two. 48-34 with about 5 seconds left to go as we see what Worth does here. Here's the glitch. The glitch gets to Slensky. Slensky's going to get over to Kavizniska. As she takes it at the buzzer, but bricks a little short. As we're going to go into the fourth quarter here, 48-34 is the Bulldogs over the Pawnee Heights Tigers. We'll be right back after this short break.
At Beck's, we are farmers at heart. For over 100 years, the Beck family has lived and farmed in central Indiana. We are proud to announce Saline River Seed, your dedicated Beck's dealers now serving farmers in northwest Kansas. At Beck's, we are committed to helping farmers seek new challenges, push boundaries, and innovate in an ever-changing industry. That's what makes Beck's different. For more information, call your Beck's local dealer, Darren Roberts, at 785-299-0126.
Family Market in downtown Quinter is here to provide fuel for Bulldogs of all ages. Come in and check out our variety of fresh produce, the large selection from the meat department, or food from the deli section. Offering weekly specials, Family Market has your family covered. Shop local, where we provide friendly smiles, a warm welcome, and service you can't find elsewhere. Family Market, a locally owned grocery store, is a proud supporter of all things Bulldog and Bulldog Athletics.
Welcome back to Quinter High School as the Quinter Bulldogs lead Pawnee Heights Tigers 48-34 as we enter the fourth quarter here. Bulldogs still having a great, fast game. Keep going, keep pushing. Seeing a little bit of more younger girls here on Pawnee Heights as Sissel Kylan came in there towards the end of the third quarter. Bulldogs trying to take a lead here and keep their streak going here. They're going up 2-0 in the season. They're a little bit of hands, trying to get something done fast. Unfortunately, Ibarra, who came in at the quarter, accidentally bounced it off a foot to the out of bounds. It's going to be Bulldogs' ball. This is going to look for something. Not seeing anything. Timeout call is going to be for the Bulldogs there. Full timeout. We need some more sponsors here then. Gove County Medical Center, your comprehensive health care provider in Northwest Kansas. Healing through care. Covering Gove County Medical Center. Kansas Land Bank, Western Kansas' favorite bank, Kansas Land Bank. Family Market, your hometown grocery, Go Big Red. GG&T Cattle Company, the Worth families are proud supporters of the Quinter Bulldogs. Aragog Seed and Man Farms, helping feed Quinter Bulldogs and the world. So, Caleb, what to the Pawnee need in this last quarter to try to come back? They're trying to scale their way back here.
Well, yeah, at one point Pawnee Heights did trail by over 20. Now trying to cut that down, they're down by 14, and it's tough to score, like we said, against this Quinter Bulldogs defense. This is the first team to draw past 30 points right there on that latter stretch of the third quarter. They're really starting to get settled down, get stuff going their way. Just stay settled down and keep climbing back with the time you got remaining.
Something I'm thinking of, I'm feeling like a lot of these Bulldogs are starting to rack up some of those fouls. So if I'm going to be Pawnee, I'm going to take it to them, trying to get that block charge. Don't drop that shoulder to avoid the charge, but let's take it to the Bulldogs. But Bulldogs are going to take the ball here out. Long pass puts Niska, trying to get to Betts, but went into the bleachers there.
And we've seen the Bulldogs really slinging the ball around similar to that, but that one really just getting away from Kwasniska, way overhead of Sage Betts.
Had one or two of those tonight, but nothing really hurting them so far. So Pawnee Heights is going to bring it down, though. Their senior point guard, Cordero Valiz, is going to try to dribble around, look for something. Byra gets it over to Abby Hands. Abby Hands gets to her sister. Her sister's going to lay it right over the rim for another two. Bulldogs aren't going to slow down from that. They're going to bring the ball real fast. Gets it to Glipsy. Glipsy tries a little short hook shot. Was able to get it rebounded by Cordillo Valiz.
And here recently, Pawnee Heights has also changed up as they're not allowing as many offensive rebounds for the Bulldogs. Really toning in on that, not allowing those second opportunity shots.
Trying to crash the board. The three there from Pelton, a little long. Tried to save it, but unfortunately was able to just wasn't able to get it in, so it's going to be Bulldogs' ball, but definitely right. Trying to get those, crash those boards, not letting so many offensive rebounds happen. Trying to get those defensive rebounds and push it on their side of the floor and try to put up points for them. Hubble Bulldogs coming for Quinter as they now bring the ball down the floor. Briggs looking for someone. Gets to Smith. Smith's over to Glipsy. Glipsy try to get it back in there on the cut for Smith, but take it away from Abby Hands.
And Abby Hands just reads that pass perfectly, steps right in between and swipes it away.
Okay. Has a lot of good potential here, being a sophomore for Pawnee Heights. A lot of young people as well. Olivia Hands, good pass to her sister. Abby Hands puts it in for another two.
And Abby Hands just really got lost by the defense there, completely open down low.
Looks like Selensky tried a save shot, misses it, but Briggs saved it. But unfortunately, Livingham's trying to get in, but picked off by Briggs. Little reverse, little short. It's going to be Briggs. Looks like Briggs stepped out. We have another sub for Pawnee. We got Hammock coming in for side, Bruce Belton. Seen her a lot tonight. Pawnee Heights got dealing with two Bulldogs. Smith tips it away and goes out of bounds. Still Pawnee ball.
Yeah, certainly Smith just showing her quick hands there, swiping that one away, pit-pocketing Cordeo Valdez.
Trying to look for something. Pawnee still trying a little bit of struggle with this press, but throw kick gets to a Bear. Bear's going to go in. Drive. Crowd's getting a little rowdy, wanting a call. Finally gets a call on a Barrow. Gonna be her third one on the night. So Bulldogs are gonna take it back down to their side. Long, some more long passes from Bulldogs, trying to just move the ball around, waste some time. Smith is gonna take a little hook shot, a little off, rebounded by Olivia Hands. It's Hands, she's herself, takes it down the floor. Gets trapped, gets into her sister, Abby Hands. She's gonna drive, one girl be blocked. No, excuse me, fouled by Gillespie.
And that from up here, it did look like Bryn Gillespie had all ball on that one, but the officials are gonna say that it is a foul, but from our vantage point, it did look to be all ball.
It did. The ball came out of her hands and might have got her a little bit there on the side after the ball was passed, but I don't know if you let that one go or not. But looks like it's going to not pay off too well for the Bulldogs. They missed their first, as Abby Hands misses her first one. And that was her fourth one, Gillespie's foul of the night. So she's only got one more. And misses her second one, so it didn't cost her much as anything but a foul. As Gillespie tries getting it down, but picked off by Abby Hands. Pawnee trying to get across half court, finally does. Cordova Valley's drives. Rivera gets it to the top, swings it around to Abby Hands. Gets it to Hammock. Hammock gets it into Olivia Hands, rolls out of the rim. It looks like a foul on the rebound. So the foul's going to be on Kelsey Selensky. Excuse me. It's going to be on the ground, so it's going to be out of bounds for Pawnee. Pawnee trying to get it in. This is a 5-second mark, so Quinter Bulldogs is going to take the ball back. Now they're not costing anything but a foul. Timeout called by Quinter Bulldogs. Full timeout here. For the Bulldogs here. We're going to see here what they're going to draw up. They're only now up by 10. There was, like I said, 14. They have not scored yet in the fourth quarter. They still dry.
Yeah, right now in this fourth quarter, they've had their struggles, and then I also want to bring up the fouls are starting to stack up for this Bulldogs team. And I know that might be something that Pawnee Heights is going to use to their advantage. Still plenty of time, and like we said earlier, they were trailing at 14 and then 20 at one point, now cutting that lead down to 10.
And coach probably called that timeout, trying to calm down their girls, make better passes, and that's what you need. They had a few little throw around and they're fouling, getting a little careless with the fouls as well. When you're doing that, you got to keep straight up as well. So we're going to see what they come out with as he calls a full timeout.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see if the Bulldogs switch up their approach with their fast pace, trying to stay and avoid those fouls or keep with it and risk fouling some more and losing a few of your players here late.
And my idea is to try to play safe defense because you're up by 10. You don't need to foul. You don't need to give up those free throws there once you get to 5-team fouls. So. But they're going to take the ball here on the opposite side of the benches. Looks like Briggs tried to drive there, give a little hook. And it looks like on the rebound, hit foul there on number 15, Olivia Hands. At the line is going to be Selensky shooting for two. Grims out the first one. That would be Hands' second foul on the night. Gets the second one in, so now finally got it since the first timeout called in the quarter. Bounce, looks like hit by Pawnee, goes out, so it's going to be Quinter ball there at the half court. But still putting on that press, putting great pressure on Pawnee. These Bulldogs are just going to try to move the ball around. Ooh, Cordero Valley is getting in there, trying to stop the ball. Looks like Pelham's going to grab it, though, move down the drive, hit a little floater. A little short, rebounded by Abby Hands. Misses as well. She rebounds it again. Looks like stopped by Selensky. Looks like Selensky's going to step out of bounds, trying to grab that block shot there by her.
Yeah, and Pawnee Heights, they grab their offensive rebound, but the Bulldogs defense doing a good job of collapsing down on Hands and not allowing her to get that second opportunity shot to go.
Right off the rebound, trying to get it to Olivia Hands, put it in, bricked it out. So jump ball is going to be Bulldog's ball here. So we've got 3:51 left. Pawnee Heights trailing by 11. Switching to sort of a zone for Pawnee there, trying to make something happen to stop that fast offense. Seems to be working a little bit. Quinter having a couple times making some of their passes up top. Long pass, almost got picked, but Selensky grabbed it. Smith's going to bring it all the way around, gets to Lipsy. Lipsy's looking around, gets to the backside of the corner to Selensky. Selensky up to Worth. Worth's going to make a move, drive. He's going to get the foul called on the drive, but it's going to be on the floor. Little tad late on the call as well, but not too bad as much time as we've seen, so we're going to keep it on the floor. That foul is going to be on Olivia Hands. It's going to be her third one of the night. There's a couple Bulldogs come in for Quinters. They're going to try to give some girls a break. Quinter inbounds the ball, still trying to move the ball around, waste a little bit of time. Another foul called on Pawnee. It's going to be on Cordell Valles. Don't know if these fouls are quite intentional or if they're just trying to play tough defense on these girls.
Right now, really helping out the Bulldogs. They're able to just hold onto the ball even longer and just keep ticking away at this clock.
And the next one, team foul is going to be shooting two for Bulldogs. Tip there by Cordell Valles, but picked up by Betts. Selensky loses it out of bounds, but tipped by Pelton there. Bulldogs still trying to move, just waste time off the clock. Real drive taken outside the Worth drive earlier. Pawnee still trying to get something back. Long overwhelm pass by Selensky. So Pawnee finally gets the ball back after a long possession there by Quinter, wasting quite a bit of time.
Yeah, the Bulldogs able to take a lot of time off that clock, like you said. But just could have taken more if they didn't have that overthrown pass that wound up going out of bounds.
Yep. Pawnee now trying to swing the ball around. Gets called for a travel on Helton as she tried getting it back up top. And you got to slow down there, try to make sure those passes are quite well and know where your feet are set. Quinter's now going to make their long pass. Fortunately, did not go over the head this time. Quinter continues to swing the ball around. Confusion who is going that to, but Quinter still comes up top with it. Another reach call on Pelton. Still going to see. Now we're going to shoot two for Gillespie at the line. It's her first one of the night. She's got a few spare if Pawnee needs them. This is short on her first one. Still leading the Pawnee Tigers by 11. And long on her second one, but rebounded by Selensky. Sat there and waited for the ball. Pawnee was hoping to get that rebound back and get the ball. Now going to shoot for another two. It's going to be on Hammock there. It's going to be her third one of the night as Selensky goes to the line and shoots two. Quinter Bulldogs going 16 for 31 before this game. 52% from the line. As a jump ball on the rebound, it's going to be Pawnee ball. Pawnee finally gets it back now. Now trailing by 12. Minute 30 left to go. Linda Hanks. Give me a foul called. Looks like Kwasniska got under Olivia the hands there when trying to make the long pass. It's going to be her fourth one of the night. I believe that's three now. Bulldogs having four fouls each. Pawnee swinging the ball around, looking for any shot. Minute 10 left to go. Pawnee finally gets it. Pawnee's going to go drive, drives all the way to Hull. Goes a little, shoots a little bit too late. Looks like that's going to say it was tipped by the Bulldogs. So it's going to be Pawnee ball underneath their hoop. As Wirt tries picking off the inbounds pass, but unfortunately hits it out of bounds. Still Pawnee ball now on the sideline. Pawnee trying to look for something here in the last 60 seconds of the game. Unfortunately, throws it away, picked off by Betts. The foul call on, looks like Pawnee. This will be on number 25, Abby Hands. This will be her second one of the night as Betts goes to the line. Shoot two. A little right on the first one. No good. 50-38, 51 seconds left. Quinter leads. A little long on the second one, but Selensky almost had the rebound. It looks like a fight for the ball between Abby Hands and Gillespie. It's going to be Bulldogs' ball there with the jump. Let's get it up to the top. The Bulldogs trying to waste some time now. And almost takes it from Worth. Worth recovers. Foul called on Pawnee again. So it's going to be on Hammock. Hemi. It's going to be her fourth one of the night. Selensky goes to the line. Excuse me, Gillespie goes to the line. Gets her first one in. 51-38. Followed by her second one going in. 52-38. Bulldogs lead by 14 with about 30 seconds left in the game. Pawnee just trying to get the ball. Gwinner still having their full court press on. Gets it underneath to Pelton, but taken away by Selensky.
That one just really grabbed away by Selensky.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. The senior right there taking it from the freshman. Not too much shooting that Pelton could have done there. She was surrounded by at least four Bulldogs. As now Selensky is going to wait out the time. And that's going to be the game for the girls. Girls win over Pawnee Heights 52-38, continuing a 3-0 lead here. Stay tuned for the boys' basketball. They're going to play Logan Hall here later tonight.
Kansas is a sixth-generation family farm located in Decatur County, Kansas. It was founded in 1878, and we still farm the original homestead. Harmony Farms Kansas has been certified organic since 1987, and we're certified by the Organic Crop Improvement Association, National Organic Producers, and in Canada, with the U.S.-Canadian Equivalency Program. Harmony Farms offers certified organic wheat, milo, and millet, both in bulk and individual packaging, along with individual bags of whole wheat flour. Harmony Farms Kansas, a proud supporter of Quinter Schools.
Quinter Sires Barnes is your Farm Bureau agent, serving the area since 2008. Give her team a call today to learn how they can make it easy to protect things that are most important to you, your home, family, farm, and future. Kinder's team is committed to offering quality products and exceptional service. If you have questions, they are just a phone call away. Kinder appreciates the opportunity to earn your business, and she and the team look forward to showing you how simple insurance can be.
GG&T Cattle Company is a fourth generation seed stock producer owned and operated by Cindy, Garrett, Crystal, Reed, and Jessica Worth. They specialize in registered Slayers, Angus, and Optimizer cattle. Join GG&T for the 49th annual production sale on February 22nd, 2024 at their ranch south of Quinter. GG&T Cattle Company, proud supporters of the Quinter Bulldogs.
Gove Community Bible Church, located in Gove, Kansas, is a Jesus-driven community that is proud to support the Quinter Bulldogs. We offer worship on Sunday mornings at 10:30 a.m. If you would like to know more about our church, visit our website at www.govecbc.com or download our Faith Life app from the QR code. Be sure to follow us on Facebook as well. Good luck, Bulldogs!
Gove County Medical Center is your 24-hour critical access hospital, located in Quinter, Kansas. Since 1925, GCMC has been providing outstanding health care to Northwest Kansas with services such as surgery, physical therapy, radiology, podiatry, orthopedics, lab, and much more. For the right care, at the right time, in the right place close to home, call 785-754-3341. GCMC is committed to others, always. Proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Kansas Land Bank is a locally owned community bank supporting community and school events. They are a full-service bank offering everything from ag loans to personal savings and checking accounts. Kansas Land Bank has a friendly staff that provides that personal touch. As one of the few locally owned community banks left in western Kansas, they strive to serve the needs of the people in our area. Kansas Land Bank remains a proud supporter of all Bulldog activities.
Mann Farms is your local AgriGold agent. For over 80 years, AgriGold has delivered quality corn and soybean seed to growers with unmatched genetic innovation and performance, utilizing local in-field trials to gain firsthand knowledge of the best product lines for the area. Let us help you with your seed selection decisions. Offering direct shipping or local seed delivery services for your seed needs. For additional information, call Shane at 785-299-0510. Mann Farms and AgriGold, proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Selensky Land and Cattle Inc. and Circle S Trucking of Park, Kansas proudly support all Bulldog activities and athletics. Curtis and Kelly, lifelong residents of Gove County, have been in the farming and cattle feeding business for over 30 years, proudly running their family business to this day. They operate a cattle feed yard and also grow wheat, corn, and livestock feed. Circle S Trucking, led by Carson Selensky, has been actively hauling needs of the local area for silage, grain, and manure for 2 years. Selensky Land and Cattle and Circle S Trucking would like to congratulate and support the Bulldogs for that successful year and wish them the best of luck.
Smoky Hill Ag is your precision ag service dealer. They offer customized agronomy for your farm, providing precision fertilizer applications with custom chemical blends. Smoky Hill Ag will create recommendations specific to each farmer's needs. With local service and competitive prices over the past 15 years, Smoky Hill Ag provides local ownership, management, and employment with community involvement. Trust them for all of your customized agronomy needs. Smoky Hill Ag, a loyal supporter of Quinter High School.
Wagner Manure Spreading LLC was established in 1997 with just two spreader trucks and one payloader. It has grown into a family-owned business in western Kansas. The Wagner family, with owners Greg and Yvonne, sons Toby, Tyler, Tanner, and their families, all specialize in the stockpiling and spreading of manure. They're also available for any of your hopper bottom needs, including grain, dry fertilizer, etc. If you need pens cleaned, we have plenty of payloader experience, as no job is too big or too small. So contact Wagner Manure Spreading LLC, proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
At Beck's, we are farmers at heart. For over 100 years, the Beck family has lived and farmed in central Indiana. We are proud to announce Saline River Seed, your dedicated Beck's dealers now serving farmers in northwest Kansas. At Beck's, we are committed to helping farmers seek new challenges, push boundaries, and innovate in an ever-changing industry. That's what makes Beck's different. For more information, call your Beck's local dealer, Darren Roberts, at 785-299-0126.
Family Market in downtown Quinter is here to provide fuel for Bulldogs of all ages. Come in and check out our variety of fresh produce, the large selection from the meat department, or food from the deli section. Offering weekly specials, Family Market has your family covered. Shop local, where we provide friendly smiles, a warm welcome, and service you can't find elsewhere. Family Market, a locally owned grocery store, is a proud supporter of all things Bulldog and Bulldog athletics.
Harmony Farms Kansas is a sixth-generation family farm located in Decatur County, Kansas. It was founded in 1878, and we still farm the original homestead. Harmony Farms Kansas has been certified organic since 1987, and we're certified by the Organic Crop Improvement Association, National Organic Producers, and in Canada, with the U.S.-Canadian Equivalency Program. Harmony Farms offers certified organic wheat, milo, and millet, both in bulk and individual packaging, along with individual bags of whole wheat flour. Harmony Farms Kansas, a proud supporter of Quinter Schools.
Quinter Sires Barnes is your Farm Bureau agent, serving the area since 2008. Give her team a call today to learn how they can make it easy to protect things that are most important to you, your home, family, farm, and future. Kinder's team is committed to offering quality products and exceptional service. If you have questions, they are just a phone call away. Kinder appreciates the opportunity to earn your business, and she and the team look forward to showing you how simple insurance can be.
GG&T Cattle Company is a fourth-generation seed stock producer owned and operated by Cindy, Garrett, Crystal, Reed, and Jessica Worth. They specialize in registered Slayers, Angus, and Optimizer cattle. Join GG&T for the 49th annual production sale on February 22, 2024 at their ranch south of Quinter. GG&T Cattle Company, proud supporters of the Quinter Bulldogs.
Gove Community Bible Church, located in Gove, Kansas, is a Jesus-driven community that is proud to support the Quinter Bulldogs. We offer worship on Sunday mornings at 10:30 a.m. If you would like to know more about our church, visit our website at www.govecbc.com or download our Faith Life app from the QR code. Be sure to follow us on Facebook as well. Good luck, Bulldogs!
Gove County Medical Center is your 24-hour critical access hospital, located in Quinter, Kansas. Since 1925, GCMC has been providing outstanding health care to Northwest Kansas with services such as surgery, physical therapy, radiology, podiatry, orthopedics, lab, and much more. For the right care, at the right time, in the right place close to home, call 785-754-3341. GCMC is committed to others, always. Proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Kansas Land Bank is a locally owned community bank supporting community and school events. They are a full-service bank offering everything from ag loans to personal savings and checking accounts. Kansas Land Bank has a friendly staff that provides that personal touch. As one of the few locally owned community banks left in western Kansas, they strive to serve the needs of the people in our area. Kansas Land Bank remains a proud supporter of all Bulldog activities.
Mann Farms is your local AgriGold agent. For over 80 years, AgriGold has delivered quality corn and soybean seed to growers with unmatched genetic innovation and performance, utilizing local in-field trials to gain firsthand knowledge of the best product lines for the area. Let us help you with your seed selection decisions. offering direct shipping or local seed delivery services for your seed needs. For additional information, call Shane at 785-299-0510. Mann Farms and AgriGold, proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Selensky Land and Cattle Inc. and Circle S Trucking of Park, Kansas proudly support all Bulldog activities and athletics. Curtis and Kelly, lifelong residents of Gove County, have been in the farming and cattle feeding business for over 30 years, proudly running their family business to this day. They operate a cattle feed yard and also grow wheat, corn, and livestock feed. Circle S Trucking, led by Carson Selensky, has been actively hauling needs of the local area for silage, grain, and manure for 2 years. Selensky Land and Cattle and Circle S Trucking would like to congratulate and support the Bulldogs for that successful year and wish them the best of luck.
Smoky Hill Ag is your precision ag service dealer. They offer customized agronomy for your farm, providing precision fertilizer applications with custom chemical blends. Smoky Hill Ag will create recommendations specific to each farmer's needs. With local service and competitive prices over the past 15 years, Smoky Hill Ag provides local ownership, management, and employment with community involvement. Trust them for all of your customized agronomy needs. Smoky Hill Ag, a loyal supporter of Quinter High School.
Wagner Manure Spreading LLC was established in 1997 with just two spreader trucks and one payloader. It has grown into a family-owned business in western Kansas. The Wagner family, with owners Greg and Yvonne, sons Toby, Tyler, Tanner, and their families, all specialize in the stockpiling and spreading of manure. They're also available for any of your hopper bottom needs, including grain, dry fertilizer, etc. If you need pens cleaned, we have plenty of payloader experience, as no job is too big or too small. So contact Wagner Manure Spreading LLC, proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, back to Quinter High School. It's the Quinter Bulldogs boys take on Logan Palco boys. We're going to see here tonight a great matchup. Both teams are 2-0. Both teams having a great win last Tuesday night. This tip-off is won by the Quinter Bulldogs. Bulldogs driving there. 42, Avery Briggs drives him in there for two, putting the Bulldogs on the board first. They now press. Logan Palco is trying to find a way. It's like number 25, Gasser, is trying to get the ball there, landing out of bounds.
Yeah, that pass just led a little bit too far out of bounds. It was from Rewell, intended for Gasser, just too far along that boundary line.
Now the Quinter Bulldogs now using their speed to show around here as number 12, Trace Kinderconnect, goes up, shoots it, misses, but gets the two, or gets the foul call. Foul's going to be called on Ryan Prewell. It's going to be his first. Kinderconnect puts in his first one, bringing the lead up to three now. Good work trying to connect. Putting both in his free throws down. You can see a lot of speed looks like tonight from both sides of the ball. The Bulldogs now pick it off from Logan Palco. Palco. So they're swinging the ball around. That's what they want to shoot. Lou lost the ball. Picked up by Logan Palco. But travel number one, Graham, Caden Graham. Losing the ball there.
And the Bulldogs' quick pace really just getting the Logan Palco Roosters out of rhythm, out of sync, about a few bad passes, and then just mental mistakes.
Yeah. Sometimes going too fast like they're there. That turnover right there got them a little too quick for their own liking and turned the ball over, but unfortunately was able to get it back. Looks like 32 Briggs is looking for Johnson underneath the hoop, threw it a little too hard and fast. Wasn't able to get it, so it goes out of bounds. It'll be Logan Palco's ball. They're now trying to bring it down. Trying not to get trapped there at the corner. Picked off by Briggs again. Bringing up for the turnover as he drives. Gets it back out. Turns around. Johnson looks to shoot, but gives it away. Rumbacher's trying to look for something to happen. Gets it inside to Slayer. Salyers. Looks like Briggs up for three, misses. Johnson saves it. Unfortunately, it was tripped by Katz on Logan Palco's lead. Now he brings it down the ball. Trapped in the corner. Finally gets it out. Swings around. Right top. Oh, from the 10-foot line. Drains it. Great shot there by Katz.
Red Katz with that deep three.
Looks like for Gumbach to try to drive, missed it, rebounded by Bulldog, missed the putback. Another long three, short, rebounded by Kenner Connect. Blair brings down the floor, tried to get it to Johnson underneath the hoop, but it's hit out of bounds off Johnson, so it'll be Logan Paco's ball. As number 44, Luke Packard comes in for Johnson. Bulldogs still up their press. Man-to-man press. No. Just speed off, brings down the floor. Looks someone hits the top number one, Graham. Graham takes a shot from the three. Banks, brims out, fight for the rebound. Gutenbacher for the Bulldogs comes on with it as he puts it down the floor. 11 Slayers, and shoots for three short, rebounded by Packard, puts it in for two, 6-3.
The Bulldog just crashing down to the basket, getting those offensive rebounds and then those second opportunity shots.
And like you said there, using their speed again, that's going to be Briggs picking it off, giving it to Kendrick Kanak as he lays it up for two. Great athleticism is what we're seeing here from the Bulldogs as we already get an early timeout from Logan Packer and from the Bulldogs trying to calm down the boys, slow down the speed. Only a 30-second timeout from the coach. So, like we said, you're keeping that press on. It's a man-to-man press, but they're still trying to get those jumps on it. It's all from Briggs as he got it down there, gave it to Kennedy Connect for the layup number two.
Yeah, this is really fast pace. Like we saw from the girls game earlier, both these Quinters teams like to establish that fast pace and just getting the other team uncomfortable and out of rhythm.
Very much so. Like you saw earlier, the girls game, the girls won pretty well by using their speed as well. Not too many turnovers here, but a lot of quick pace from the Bulldogs, 20% on their offense and their defense. We like to see it. Haven't seen too much of a Logan Palco offense setup. A lot on three from, I believe it was Katz there at the 10-foot line, drained it there, but that's about the only offensive play we've seen happen for them. So let's see if they can get the ball down the floor. Under the trap, get across the floor to 23 Powell as he puts it in for two. Great look there by Palco getting across the floor. Bulldogs don't respond. As a great pass from Briggs to Packard. Packard lays one right over the rim. Bulldogs, even if they make it, they're not slowing down. They're going to bring that ball with a lot of pressure. So it looks like Katz trying to dribble through a couple Bulldogs. It's going to be a foul call on Kinder Connect there, his first of the night. Two on the floor. As number 20 Sparks comes in for Logan Palco. So Katz is going to receive it on the other side of the floor as he brings it back. Logan Palco trying to throw it around, see if something's open. Katz faking a shot. Palco trying to run, set something up. Shoot for Katz. Katz is going to drive. Lays it in, but he's going to get the charge call on him. Great job by Packard there, standing his ground. It's going to be his first one of the night. Team's at two. So Quinter's going to inbound it. Takes the other ball, trying to look for some side. Gets tipped away and picked up by Katz. Katz bringing it down. Try getting away, now picked away by Briggs. Briggs picked away again and picked up by Graham from Logan Palco. Logan Palco slowing it down a little bit. Cats about loses it out of bounds. He's able to keep his there. Logan Paul still looking for something. His number three, Morgan, loses it out of bounds, so it's going to be Bulldogs ball. As a couple Bulldogs come in, give them and their players a break. Logan Palco putting on a press. A little bit more of a press. Tipped away by Cats out of bounds. It's still going to be Quinter's ball. Two different presses tonight. Quinter putting on a man-to-man, and Logan Palco putting on a zone here. But almost worked for them if Cats could have held on to the ball. Logan Palco playing a 1-3-1. Kendrick Connect got the free throw on, dribbles, take a shot, short. Rebounded by Palu, the free throw. Cats trying to look for something. Packard playing out wide after the long three made by him earlier. Sparks looking for something to look. Gives it back to Cats. Cats trying to move. Long three from the 10-foot line. Short. Fight for the rebound. Finally grabbed by number one, Katura. For the Bulldogs. This is going to be down the floor now. Number 50 in the corner. Bridges. Kinder connect on the Packer. Packer underneath with two. Oh, Barco's there. Puts it in for two. 12-5 here with about 2 minutes to remain in the quarter. Cats trying to bring the ball back down now. Wants to drive. Kicks it underneath. Gets it underneath to 23 Freewall. Puts it in for two and got the foul. There's an extra free throw line. Foul's going to be on number 50, Cameron Bridges. As number 10 for Logan Palco comes in, Ashmore. Makes it a three-point play. So now 12-8 here with about 1:50 left in the quarter. Where Bulldogs trying to figure out how to beat this zone. Gets it across half court. Kinder Connect in the corner with a three. Long. Tipped off. Puro out of bounds. There's going to be Quinter ball underneath their hoop. Like Logan Palco is going to stick in there, 2-3. Gumbaka tries to make something happen, gets Kinder Connect in the corner. Kinder Connect across to Katera. Katera drives a little bit, backs out, gives it back up to Gumbaka. Gumbaka inside to Bridges. Bridges out to Katara. Katara long three. Little Con got the contact, misses the three. He got the contact. He's going to go to the line to shoot three free throws. Foul's going to be on number three, Cameron Morgan. His first one on the night. Team's third. Excuse me. He was on the floor, so he's not going to shoot the three free throws. Katara takes the hole and gets an offensive call. Came a little too hard there. So it's going to be his first. Number one, Graham, comes back into the floor for Logan Palco. Cats are now going to try to bring down the ball against the Bulldogs here. Now loses the ball. Gets it down there to number 20, Sparks. Sparks doesn't have a stolen by Gumbacher. Gumbacher gets Kinder Connect down the floor. Kinder Connect kicks it back out. Packard from the elbow, a little long, rebounded by Packard. Power dribble, a little floater missed, rebounded by Bridges. Bridges is going to get called. Bridges is going to go up, shoot a miss. Got the free throws. Fouls going to be called on number four. Cats is going to be his second one. It's the first one in. Couple Bulldogs, 32 Avery Briggs, number 11 Sellers, comes in for the Bulldogs. Rims out the second one, rebounded by Puro. Puro now bring the ball down by himself. Moving the ball around. Morgan's got it. Morgan gets it over to Graham. Graham back over to Puro. Puro with a long three. Got it. 13-11 now. About 20 seconds left. Bulldog caught in the corner. Briggs comes to help. Briggs gets it down to the Bridges. Bridges to Sailors. Sailors is going to get it to Packer. Packer's going to power drive. Little shot. No. Off the backboard. Rebounded by Sparks. Sparks is going to hit Graham. Graham's with a pre-war. Long shot. Off. Rebounded. Rebound by Morgan and was able to put it in to tie it at the buzzer. 13-13 here at the end of the first quarter. Really good fight here between both teams. We'll see what they have here in the start of the second quarter.
At Beck, we are farmers at heart. For over 100 years, the Beck family has lived and farmed in central Indiana. We are proud to announce Saline River Seed, your dedicated Beck's dealers now serving farmers in northwest Kansas. At Beck, we are committed to helping farmers seek new challenges, push boundaries, and innovate in an ever-changing industry. That's what makes Beck's different. For more information, call your Beck's local dealer, Darren Roberts, at 785-299-0126.
Family Market in downtown Quinter is here to provide fuel for Bulldogs of all ages. Come in and check out our variety of fresh produce, the large selection from the meat department, or food from the deli section. Offering weekly specials, Family Market has your family covered. Shop local where we provide friendly smiles, a warm welcome, and service you can't find elsewhere. Family Market, a locally owned grocery store, is a proud supporter of all things Bulldog and Bulldog Athletics.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, back to Bulldog Quinter High School as they host Logan Paul in the second round of the Castle competition. As we go here in the second quarter, it's all tied up at 13. Caleb, what do you think both teams are doing well here?
Well, right now, Logan Palco really climbing back into this one. They were down, tying it up off that buzzer beater. The Bulldogs, they've had a lot of mid-range jumpers that they just can't get to go their way. They got to find a way to get those to fall.
Indeed. Logan Palco is going to come out with the ball here. Looks like a pass, loose ball underneath the hoop. Going to call it a jump ball. It'll be Bulldog ball here.
And the Bulldogs doing just an excellent job of collapsing down on that. Four white jerseys in on the ball.
Indeed, definitely a lot of great defense here. Still looks like they're going to have a little bit of trouble here getting those corners, opposite corners there on the low end. Oh, it looks like Johnson threw the ball a little too early for Briggs, and he wasn't ready for losing it as Graham picks it up for the Logan Packers. So they'll get the ball back. Packers trying to swing the ball around. Graham looking for something to happen. Graham not trying to get it to Morgan. Morgan wasn't looking for it. So it looks like went out on a Logan Packer, so it's going to be Bulldog's ball.
Yeah, Morgan was coming in on his cut, just not expecting a pass right there as he was looked the complete opposite way and just miscommunication between the two.
All the way down to Johnson. Long pass, gets it over to Quintero. Quintero to Bridges. Bridges up to Johnson. Johnson looks to drive. Hits one jet. I actually forgot he had a quick dribble there. So he has a double dribble calling on him. So it's going to be Logan Paco's ball. Late to the press was Johnson. Again, another look for Morgan, but just was not looking. Looks like he was trying to set a screen there. Unfortunately, we're just a little bit too early on the pass. A couple Bulldogs come in. Also, another Logan Paco player comes in. Quinter going to try to break the press. But Johnson, looking for Johnson underneath the hoop, had a little bit too far lead, lost it out of bounds. So still tied up at 13. So you're near the train to score first. But Johnson picks the ball right out of the rim. Slayers with a long three, short, big rebound. Sorry, by a Prowl. His Cat's now going to bring it down the floor, trying to set up an offense. It's Ashmore. Ashmore running into Graham. Graham now has the ball. Gets it over to Sparks. Sparks looking for something. Gets the screen for Pruitt out. Turns back around. Loses the ball. Picked up by Johnson. Johnson driving all the way. Misses the layup, but saved by his teammate, Slayer. Salyers.
And Johnson getting that steal. He was just right there in the perfect spot. As soon as he turned around, Johnson was able to get a hand in there and take it away the other way.
Indeed. Logan Paco breaks the press, and then moving down. Cats driving the hole, makes a little move, lays it in for two, ties it back up at 15, so 5:45.
Yeah, and Red Cats is going to be one that Logan Paco looks to averaging over 16 points a game.
Well, when you're 6'4", you got a lot of chances for rebounds and putting them up over their team. Looks like Morgan's going to come back in here for Sparks. There's a time, full timeout is called here. For the Bulldogs. Now we're going to thank some sponsors for the Bulldogs here. Family Market, your hometown grocer, Go Big Red, GG&T Cattle Company, the Worth families are proud supporters of the Quinter Bulldogs. We got Seed and Man Farms, helping feed the Quinter Bulldogs and the world. Gove County Bible Church, we have Community Bible Church, excuse me. Jesus Driven Community, we support the Quinter Bulldogs. St. Lane River Seed. Contact Darren Roberts, your Beck Area Seed Dealer. Farmers and Bulldog fans at heart. Wagner Manure Shredding. Proud supporters of the Quinter Bulldogs. And thrilled to help spread Bulldog pride. Kendra Barnes at Farm Bureau Financial Services. Here to help you protect what matters most in life. Kaiser Angus. Certified Angus Beef Sellers. And proud supporters of the Quinter Bulldogs. Come back here all tied up. 15-15. Both teams making one bucket each. Both teams putting on a strong press. Logan Packer with the zone. Quinter with more of a man-to-man. Still have a both turnovers, both losing, having a couple steals here. So it's going to be Logan Packer's ball as we come out. Looks like Morgan's pass to Cats is a little bit out of his reach. So it goes out of bounds. It's going to be Quinter Bulldogs.
Logan Palco, they really haven't even been able to put up a shot here recently. Because a lot of their possessions have just really been going nowhere with these miscues and just simple mistakes of throwing it away and turning it over.
Indeed, that's going to be Sawyers with a little short floater, a little bit too far. That's now going to bring it back down the floor, trying to set something up. Not quite past the court. Gets it down to Morgan underneath the hoop, but loses the ball. Gets it back, though, as he takes a quick shot, a little long. Got by Briggs. A little bit of a fast shot there. Don't know if quite needed, but Briggs brings it back down the floor. Looks to shoot. Stopped by Morgan. Salyers tries to get it over to Greenbacher, but it's just a little bit out of his reach that time. A lot of turnovers just without Paco's having too much to help with.
Well, that pass intended for Briggs just behind him, wanting to get it to him, but Ryan Brewu really in his body in the way, so a tough pass for Sawyers to make and just behind him.
Indeed. So Logan Palco is going to bring the ball down now. Cast the main leader here. Trying to look for something, gets it out to Morgan. Almost loses the ball. Morgan trying to find something, trying to still hold on to the ball. Gets to the Cats. Cats look for a screen. Doesn't get it. Drives. Sawyers. Kinder can't tries pulling a long three. Miss. So Avery Briggs comes up with a rebound. Gives it to Greenbacher. Looks to shoot. Nothing there. Briggs over the Kinder connect. Kinder connect back to Greenbacher. Look for Kinder connect again. Got Briggs in the corner. Takes a long high three. Off. Rebounded by Kinder connect. Greenbacher drives. Kicks it back out to Briggs. Briggs another floater. Long rebounded by Cat. Yeah, so it's going to be Logan Packer's ball as they bring it down the floor. Just looks to shoot long three. Drain. So now Logan takes the lead for the first time in the game, 15-18. Bridges gets it to Henry Connect. Henry Connect throws across Moonbacher. Moonbacher takes his turn for a three, a little off. Five for the rebound. Same team, rebounded by Kinder Connect. Short on his putback. Rebounded by Crow. A little bit of contact. Crow won the foul, but nothing called. Morgan gets to Katz at the corner. Katz with the three. Short. Rebounded by Packard. Gets Kinder Connect at the corner. Back up to Moonbacher. Packer with the free throw line. Missed. Rebounded by the 6'4 tall Cats.
And their Packer had an open mid-range jumper, and still the Bulldogs struggling to get those ones to go for him.
Another three from Ashmore. Rimmed out. Rebounded by the Bulldogs. He steals it back, though, as he tries going up. He's going to get a foul call on Grunbacher as he tries to steal it back. It's going to be on the floor underneath the hoop.
Grunbacher, you can tell, disagrees with that call, and from here it looked like he just stripped it out of his hands cleanly. But like you said, the foul is going to be called.
Yep, it's going to be his first one of the night, so he's got not too much to worry about. 2:44 left as the Bulldogs trail by three. Katz gives it in Imperial as he tries to put up a reverse, rebounded by Bridges. Kinder Connect now is going to bring it down the floor by speed. Gives it to Packer. Packer lays the move for Key. 17-18 with about 2:30 left here in the half.
And Rhett Katz losing his footing there, which allows for the wide open shot from Packer.
Yeah, very unfortunate for him. Great job by Packer making sure he had that room. Crow looking to shoot. Doesn't take it. Looking inside to Sparks, but it looks like it's going to be a foul call on Grunbacher again, so that's the second one back-to-back. Only fouls this quarter. So Sparks inbounds the ball. Gets it over to Morgan. Morgan tries to get the Cats, but almost picked off by Packard. Cats rebound and gets it. Pack drives and misses the shot, but gets the block from Bridges. Bridges not too happy about that call. About 2:01 left here, 17-18, as Katz goes to the line for his free throws. Little short on the first one. Trying to extend their lead now by two. Off on second, rebounded by Bridges that time. As now Bulldogs push down the floor. Kinder Connect looks to shoot nothing. Grunbacher swings it around. Tears looking for something to happen. Gets it over to Grunbacher. Grunbacher in the corner of Kinder Connect. His three's long. Bounces off Katz, rebounded by Bridges. And rebounded by Packer off of Bridges' missed putback. He gets a foul call here for Packer. Now he goes to the line to shoot two. This one's going to be called on Morgan. Drains the first one, tying up at 18. Sires and Bridges, or Briggs, excuse me, comes back into the game. Gets the second one. Now they take the lead back here with about a minute 42 left. 19-18 Bulldogs. Kinder Connect trying to pick a pass. Katz doesn't get fall for it. Sproul trying to look for something to happen. Loses the ball. Kinder Connect dives for it. Goes out of bounds off of Kinder Connect. Nice hustle from number 12 there. Run back a little again. Inbound the ball. Now Katz is going to try to take it down the floor. As he avoids trying to get trapped in the corner. Gets it underneath to Ashmore. Ashmore gets it over to Sparks. Sparks puts it in for two. They take back the lead. 19-20. We've got a minute 15 left. Couture stuck in the corner. Gets it over to Kinder Connect. Kinder Connect fails. Packer goes up. misses it, rebounded by Sales. And no call as he tries to go put it back up. 1-3 from Cats, off, rebounded by Morgan, but tipped out by Avery Briggs. So 55 left to go in the half. Bulldogs trail by one, 19-20. Logan, the ball's put down. The Logan Packers able to get it in time. Well, great speed by Kendrick Connector. Running around, probably get a shot. Cats drive. Takes a shot. Looking for something. Going to get a travel called on him. Howling a little hop there, trying to get it underneath. Not nothing there. So 44 left to go.
Yeah, and Cats down there on the baseline. Found himself stuck. Picked up his dribble, and no one really came down to help. Tried to do something. Just called with the travel.
Tua finally gets the ball, trying to get back. Pushes the ball, gets it inside to Sarris. Lee lays it up for two. They take the ball, lead back. 21-20. 30 left to go. This guy's looking for something. Cats sees Morgan on the floor, but so does Bridges. Morgan tries to hook shot, misses. Bridges rebounds. Packer wasn't looking as the pass, so Cats gets back as Ashmore goes up. Misses it, though, and knocked out by Morgan. So it's going to be Quinter Bulldogs ball with 13 line left to go. As Johnson checks in for Packard. Packard looked like he needed the break.
On those last few drives from Logan Palco, they had open lanes, but the pursuit from the Bulldogs chasing them down and knocking them away.
Yeah, I think they're just a little bit of worry about getting the block. But here comes Sailors, gets it in to Johnson. Johnson, a little too hard off the board. A lot of contact, no foul call. Long three off the backboard, misses the rim. So that's the half here for Logan Paco and the Quinter Bulldogs as we go into the half. 21-20 as the Bulldogs lead.
Harmony Farms Kansas is a sixth-generation family farm located in Decatur County, Kansas. It was founded in 1878, and we still farm the original homestead. Harmony Farms Kansas has been certified organic since 1987, and we're certified by the Organic Crop Improvement Association, National Organic Producers, and in Canada with the U.S.-Canadian Equivalency Program. Harmony Farms offers certified organic wheat, milo, and millet, both in bulk and individual packaging, along with individual bags of whole wheat flour. Harmony Farms Kansas, a proud supporter of Quinter Schools.
Kinder Sires Barnes is your farm bureau agent, serving the area since 2008. Give her team a call today to learn how they can make it easy to protect things that are most important to you, your home, family, farm, and future. Kinder's team is committed to offering quality products and exceptional service. If you have questions, they are just a phone call away. Kinder appreciates the opportunity to earn your business, and she and the team look forward to showing you how simple insurance can be.
GG&T Cattle Company is a fourth generation seed stock producer owned and operated by Cindy, Garrett, Crystal, Reed, and Jessica Worth. They specialize in registered Slayers, Angus, and Optimizer cattle. Join GG&T for the 49th annual production sale on February 22nd, 2024 at their ranch south of Quinter. GG&T Cattle Company, proud supporters of the Quinter Bulldogs.
Gove Community Bible Church, located in Gove, Kansas, is a Jesus-driven community that is proud to support the Quinter Bulldogs. We offer worship on Sunday mornings at 10:30 a.m. If you would like to know more about our church, visit our website at www.govecbc.com or download our Faith Life app from the QR code. Be sure to follow us on Facebook as well. Good luck, Bulldogs!
Gove County Medical Center is your 24-hour critical access hospital located in Quinter, Kansas. Since 1925, GCMC has been providing outstanding health care to Northwest Kansas with services such as surgery, physical therapy, radiology, podiatry, orthopedics, lab, and much more. For the right care, at the right time, in the right place close to home, call 785-754-3341. GCMC is committed to others, always. proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Kansas Land Bank is a locally owned community bank supporting community and school events. They are a full-service bank offering everything from ag loans to personal savings and checking accounts. Kansas Land Bank has a friendly staff that provides that personal touch. As one of the few locally owned community banks left in Western Kansas, they strive to serve the needs of the people in our area. Kansas Land Bank remains a proud supporter of all Bulldog activities.
Mann Farms is your local AgriGold agent. For over 80 years, AgriGold has delivered quality corn and soybean seed to growers with unmatched genetic innovation and performance, utilizing local in-field trials to gain firsthand knowledge of the best product lines for the area. Let us help you with your seed selection decisions. Offering direct shipping or local seed delivery services for your seed needs. For additional information, call Shane at 785-299-0510. Mann Farms and AgriGold, proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Selensky Land and Cattle Inc. and Circle S Trucking of Park, Kansas proudly support all Bulldog activities and athletics. Curtis and Kelly, lifelong residents of Gove County, have been in the farming and cattle feeding business for over 30 years, proudly running their family business to this day. They operate a cattle feed yard and also grow wheat, corn, and livestock feed. Circle S Trucking, led by Carson Selensky, has been actively hauling needs of the local area for silage, grain, and manure for 2 years. Selensky Land and Cattle and Circle S Trucking would like to congratulate and support the Bulldogs for that successful year and wish them the best of luck.
Smoky Hill Ag is your precision ag service dealer. They offer customized agronomy for your farm, providing precision fertilizer applications with custom chemical blends. Smoky Hill Ag will create recommendations specific to each farmer's needs. With local service and competitive prices over the past 15 years, Smoky Hill Ag provides local ownership, management, and employment with community involvement. Trust them for all of your customized agronomy needs. Smoky Hill Ag, a loyal supporter of Quinter High School.
Wagner Manure Spreading LLC was established in 1997 with just two spreader trucks and one payloader. It has grown into a family-owned business in Western Kansas. The Wagner family, with owners Greg and Yvonne, sons Toby, Tyler, Tanner, and their families, all specialize in the stockpiling and spreading of manure. They're also available for any of your hopper bottom needs, including grain, dry fertilizer, etc. If you need pens cleaned, we have plenty of payloader experience, as no job is too big or too small. So contact Wagner Manure Spreading LLC, proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
At Beck, we are farmers at heart. For over 100 years, the Beck family has lived and farmed in central Indiana. We are proud to announce Saline River Seed, your dedicated Beck's dealers now serving farmers in northwest Kansas. At Beck's, we are committed to helping farmers seek new challenges, push boundaries, and innovate in an ever-changing industry. That's what makes Beck's different. For more information, call your Beck's local dealer, Darren Roberts, at 785-299-0126.
Family Market in downtown Quinter is here to provide fuel for Bulldogs of all ages. Come in and check out our variety of fresh produce, the large selection from the meat department, or food from the deli section. Offering weekly specials, Family Market has your family covered. Shop local, where we provide friendly smiles, a warm welcome, and service you can't find elsewhere. Family Market, a locally owned grocery store, is a proud supporter of all things Bulldog and Bulldog Athletics.
Harmony Farms Kansas is a sixth-generation family farm located in Decatur County, Kansas. It was founded in 1878, and we still farm the original homestead. Harmony Farms Kansas has been certified organic since 1987, and we're certified by the Organic Crop Improvement Association, National Organic Producers, and in Canada, with the U.S.-Canadian Equivalency Program. Harmony Farms offers certified organic wheat, milo, and millet, both in bulk and individual packaging, along with individual bags of whole wheat flour. Harmony Farms Kansas, a proud supporter of Quinter Schools.
Kinder Sires Barnes is your Farm Bureau agent, serving the area since 2008. Give her team a call today to learn how they can make it easy to protect things that are most important to you, your home, family, farm, and future. Kinder's team is committed to offering quality products and exceptional service. If you have questions, they are just a phone call away. Kinder appreciates the opportunity to earn your business, and she and the team look forward to showing you how simple insurance can be.
GG&T Cattle Company is a fourth-generation seed stock producer owned and operated by Cindy, Garrett,
Crystal, Reed, and Jessica Worth. They specialize in registered Solaires, Angus, and Optimizer cattle. Join GG&T for the 49th annual production sale on February 22nd, 2024 at their ranch south of Quinter. GG&T Cattle Company, proud supporters of the Quinter Bulldogs.
Gove Community Bible Church, located in Gove, Kansas, is a Jesus-driven community that is proud to support the Quinter Bulldogs. We offer worship on Sunday mornings at 10:30 a.m. If you would like to know more about our church, visit our website at www.govecbc.com or download our Faith Life app from the QR code. Be sure to follow us on Facebook as well. Good luck, Bulldogs!
Gove County Medical Center is your 24-hour critical access hospital, located in Quinter, Kansas. Since 1925, GCMC has been providing outstanding health care to Northwest Kansas with services such as surgery, physical therapy, radiology, podiatry, orthopedics, lab, and much more. For the right care, at the right time, in the right place close to home, call 785-754-3341. GCMC is committed to others, always. Proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, back to Quinter High School as your Quinter Bulldogs are hosting Logan Palco tonight. Bulldogs go up 21-20 at the half here as we come back out. Both teams have an impressive half. Both teams have turnovers, ups and downs. How do you think both teams are going to fare out here at the end?
Well, yeah, that first half, like you said, ups and downs. It's been a really defensive-oriented game so far, just 41 combined points. And there in the second quarter, it was a real struggle for either team to score much. But both teams just got to stay true to their game, moving the ball around, don't play the other team's ball, just stay true to yourself in the second half.
Like I said, both teams struggling. Logan Pine had a chance there at the end with a couple missed open lanes too hot off the glass, a little scared by the speed coming at them from the Bulldogs. But Logan Palco is going to take it here to start the half. It's going to be definitely a really close down to the wire game. Sometimes we like to see those as well. So Quinter's still going to come out in their man-to-man press on everybody. Probably going to take across half court there. Met by two Bulldogs. Probably get open. Katz is able to bring it. Back to Prowl. Dinnerknecht almost got it away from him. Did get away from him, but looks like it came off Johnson or Salyers. So it's going to be Logan Palco's ball still.
And great help defense from the Bulldogs. You had two other Bulldogs rushing in on that cut.
Very much so. Cavs makes a move in the middle, misses. Hit off of Grunbacher there, so it's going to still be Logan Palco's ball. A lot of fighting for the rebound, like to see that. That's a nice move, just couldn't be able to get it to sink there. Cat's still looking for something, finds Graham. Graham finds Prowl. Prowl gets inside to Morgan. Morgan takes a fade. Puts it in for two for the first points of the second half. Takes the lead back 21-22. Looks to shoot, nothing there. Salyers looks to shoot again, gets inside to Johnson. Johnson's going to use it up and floats it, responds with his 2 points. Not too much to beat the man. Pass here. Bridges missed for a steal there. Morgan didn't want it, gives it to Graham. Graham back to Morgan. Move over to Prowl. Gets it to Katz. Katz looking for Sparks. Screen for Sparks. Gets a screen. Looks drive. Nothing there. Kicks it to Sparks. Sparks is going to try his chance at a three. Hard off the run. Hits the Kinderknecht. Kinderknecht going all the way down. Lays it up for two. They now extend their lead 25-22. It's putting hard pressure on there on Katz. They're getting it over the Prowl. Prowl just getting across half court. Dealing with two Bulldogs on him. Morgan's going to be all by himself. Morgan gets it over to Katz. Katz looking for something. Thinking about shooting. Just the drive. Nothing there. Looking for a cutter from Prowl, but wasn't there, so kicks it back up to the top. Just taking the shot. Gets it to Graham. Graham gets it over to Prowl. Looks like a block on Kinder Connect. It's going to be his second of the night.
And Morgan was just standing there trying to hold a screen, and Kinder Connect pushing through him, making it a pretty easy call for the officials.
Yeah, sometimes he's got to be a little bit easier there and try to get up or down on it. So Logan Palco, Cass is going to drive. Cass is going to take a nice little floater as it goes in there, trying to close that lead. Sellers barely gets the ball in as Goodenbacher saves it. Bridges, not quite a shot. Long pass, trying to get the Sailors. Was a little bit over his head. So as Packard comes in for Sailors. Kinder Connect blocked the inbound pass, still went out of bounds. So now it's going to be on the baseline. Blocks it again. Open recovered by Packard. Great work by him. As Goodenbacher goes to go up, Carrillo misses it. Cass comes down with the rebound. And it's going to be a hold call on Kinder Connect there for the rebound.
Going back a little, though, I want to give a lot of credit to Packard on that save, tipping it right back in into the hands of Kinder Connect. They just couldn't capitalize and finish down low.
That's great work by his team being able to see the floor and seeing it ringing out. But Kinder Connect's going to go out as Quinter comes in for the Bulldogs. Katz is going to bring the ball down. Needs two balls in the corner. Sparks is open underneath the hoop, but finally met by Briggs. Prowl with the long three, rolled out. Fight for the rebound. Came up with Packard. Packard long pass to Katira. Katira going up with a layup. Off, but gets the foul call. A little bit of contact under there, so he's going to go shoot two. Fouls no problem. Shoot me Creel. Give me a second out of the night. First one for two is in. As Ashmore comes in for Prio. And he makes his second one. Similarly, 27-24 here in the third quarter. So Morgan looking to go. Trying not to get caught in that corner. Gets to Ashmore. Ashmore sees Graham underneath, just a little bit outside.
Yeah, he had Graham there, but Kane Johnson doing a great job of switching right last second and getting in front of that.
Very much so. They're going a lot of very fast, so they're making a lot of turnovers here. Looks like Katura had a little bit of hop there when he picked up his ball, so he's going to call for a travel. So back to Logan Palco's ball on their side. Parker trying to find some. Moving the ball around. Cass looking for a screen. Fakes throws the opposite way. Gets it inside to Morgan. Morgan fake throw. Tried to get inside to Graham, but picked off by Goodenbacher. Goodenbacher's going to go try to get it down. Try getting inside to Katara. Bounced off of Logan Paul's leg there, and they were able to recover it. As Cass now bring down the ball. Oh. So Katz gets it over to Morgan in the corner. Morgan hands it off the three. Rebounded by Katara. Now Briggs brings it down the floor. Walker gets it into Johnson. Johnson over to Packard. Packard tries to go up. A lot of contact. No foul call. I was a little bit rough about that. Katz now pushing the ball down quite quick. Looking to shoot. Nothing there. Does shoot. Drains the three. Tying it up at 27. Great shot there by Katz. He's going to need my Guttenbacher. Packer in the corner. Packer trying to get to Johnson. Johnson hit and then lost the ball. So now Logan Palco is going to take it back. Sparks trying to move there, but end up traveling. As now Bridges and Sailors comes back into the game. Looks like it's going to be for Johnson and Packard. Bridges open three, doesn't take it, gets down to Bridges. Bridges is going to put it in for two.
And great decision there from Briggs. Had the open three, but then he sees Bridges down low, wide open, gives it to him.
Well, don't need a four. It was open for a shot, but those ones are a lot easier to take. So the Sparks trying to look for something. Sailors knocks away, but saved by Ashmore. Gets it out to Morgan. Morgan drives. Morgan, little layup, rolls off the rim, rebounded by Bridges. And as he's trying to get it out to Tara, it's going to be a foul, number three, Morgan. Cameron Morgan, that's going to be his third, team second. Sailors can get it to Bridges. Bridges looking for Quinter, but picked off by Ashmore. Trying to get this to Brad. Brio trying to look for something. Fencing across. Good screen by Sparks. Brio gets it to Morgan. Morgan to Katz. Katz with a three. Fade. Puts it in. Takes the lead. 29-30 now. Bridges trying to return the favor, and he does! 32-30. That's wrong, returning the message. A lot of contact there. It was like Quintero wasn't quite set by the time Katz got there, so he's going to get the foul called on him. It's going to be his second. As number one, Caden Graham, comes back in the game as a timeout from Quinter is going to be called. 30 seconds here. Great back-to-back threes there. We love to see it. Bridges saw the open three, knew they had to respond. He's going to take it that time. I really appreciate it coming from there.
Yeah, Briggs, great response, like you said, from that three earlier on the other side from Rhett Katz, leaving him open like that. And Briggs, a good outside shooter, shows it.
Very much so. We'll see what Quinter's going to come out after this timeout, probably just to slow him down here and try to cross it some, because they don't want to give up that three. Katz is a great shooter. We saw him make a 10-footer there at the very start of the game. Got the two fadeaway threes there in deep. So he's a deep shooter, maybe 6'4", can dive in the inside. That's someone you really got to lock down.
Yeah, got to watch their leading scorer in Katz. He does have four threes already tonight. Averages just over 16 points a game, so definitely got to key in on him.
Definitely. So we'll see what they do as they come out, as they have the ball. Drew Creel. Katz is going to receive the ball on the other side of the court. This crowd's getting loud here while Logan Palco has the ball. It's Creel shoots, but it's tipped by Bridges. Got by Slayer, or Salyers. Here with Katara. Katara looks to shoot, fakes it, gets it over. Guttenbacher gets inside of Bridges. Bridges goes up, misses. He rebounds it, misses again. Rebounded by Katz. About a minute 20 left. Bulldogs lead 32-30. Katz looking for something. Tries to drive on the baseline. Going to get a push call on Quinter. It's going to be on Salyers. It's going to be his first one of the night. Team's fourth. Next one's bonus. Brio tries to get to Graham. Graham gets a cast. Katz with this three. A little off. Rebounded by Guttenbacher. Guttenbacher trying to push it down the floor. No one else there. Tries to put it up. He's going to get the foul call from this one on Katz. So he's going to go to the line and shoot two.
Yeah, Katz running right side Guttenbacher. Guttenbacher just a step ahead of him. We're just going to have Katz reach his arm out and draw the foul.
Yeah, it's going to be his third one on the night. Team's third as well. So as Greenbacher puts in his first one, extending the lead by three. So it looks like Sparks is going to come in for Katz, giving him a break. We're going to need him in the fourth. Make sure he doesn't get too many fouls as well. He puts in the second one. Now a two-bucket. They need to at least tie or take the lead. So good free throw shooting there by Greenbacher. Bridges being a little bit too physical there with Grill. He's going to call for a foul. It's going to be his third one of the night. Team's fifth. Should go to the line here.
And right now, in that bonus, this is an opportunity for Logan Palco with a little bit of time left here in the third to start getting right back neck and neck.
Yep. Put it in. Staying out just with the bucket away from the Quinter Bulldogs as Packard comes in for Bridges. And short it. To Mean. Logan Paco needing the three to tie it. He gets it up. Gutenbacher gets in the corner. Couture is going to take a chance with the three. A little long. Rebounded by Sellers. Blocked by. Looked like that was Graham, Caden Graham. Good work there, but picked off by Gutenbacher from the pass to Prio. Asalios gets it inside, puts it in for the and one. It's a foul call. He goes in line, shoot one, try to make this a three-point play. This one's going to be called on number 20, Caleb Sparks. So 32 seconds left to go. Asalios is going to try to extend their lead by six. And rims out. Five for the rebound. It's going to go off of Packard. So lead still stays at five. Need a two and a three to tie for Logan Hackle. 30 seconds left to go in the quarter. As Morgan tries bringing it down and gets an offensive. So he might have extended his arm there. So it's going to be four on him. It's going to be his team's fifth. So he gets subbed out here. So Katz comes back into the game. We'll see if he can. He's got to be careful too since he's got three. So we got 25 seconds left to go in the quarter. Chura gets it over to Gutenbacher. Gutenbacher gets it over to Sires. Sires looking for Gutenbacher. Sitting up top, trying to waste some time. Riggs gets it up, back up to Packard. Packard over to Gutenbacher. Gutenbacher gets far out to shoot. Drives in. Off the hard backboard, no foul call. Packard gets it, uses it. Sires comes up with it and puts it in for two at the buzzer. So they're going to take the lead even more here. 38-31 as we head into the fourth. Real tight closer as well. A whole fourth quarter left. We'll play out that.
Kansas Land Bank is a locally owned community bank supporting community and school events. They are a full service bank offering everything from ag loans to personal savings and checking accounts. Kansas Land Bank has a friendly staff that provides that personal touch. As one of the few locally owned community banks left in Western Kansas, they strive to serve the needs of the people in our area. Kansas Land Bank remains a proud supporter of all Bulldog activities.
Mann Farms is your local AgriGold agent. For over 80 years, AgriGold has delivered quality corn and soybean seed to growers with unmatched genetic innovation and performance, utilizing local in-field trials to gain firsthand knowledge of the best product lines for the area. Let us help you with your seed selection decisions. Offering direct shipping or local seed delivery services for your seed needs. For additional information, call Shane at 785-299-0510. Mann Farms and AgriGold, proud supporters of the Bulldogs.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, back to Quinter High School as the Bulldogs are leading Logan Palco 38-31 there as Sellers put up a buzzer there to extend their lead. It looks like we're going to have a great matchup here in the fourth quarter. Both teams keeping it really fast, really tight. Palco's starting to get a little bit of foul trouble, so you really got to watch that. Bulldogs are going to take it here to start off fourth. So he's going to get the Briggs. Briggs looking for something. He's going to swing it all the way down there to Gunbacher. He's going to dribble a little bit. Tries to drive on the baseline. It's stopped. Gonna connect, gets it over to Briggs. Briggs gonna shoot for the three off. He tipped out, got by Gutenbacher. This is Boss Elliott. Gutenbacher's gonna try his hand for three short. Tipped out by Sellers. Fight between him and Katz. So it's gonna be Logan Packer's ball. Logan Packer should tend to bring down the floor. Briggs tries to pick it off there, was unable to. Katz is in the corner now. Gets it up through at the top. Looking around, looking for somebody. Katz comes out for him. Katz trying to get a screen there from Ram. Nothing happened. Katz from the 10-foot line. And misses the completely. Patriots are too happy about that one.
Yeah, we saw Katz hit one from that range earlier. Right now, trailing in the fourth, you just want to run your offense and get better looks.
Not too much of an offense they look like. Looks like they're just trying to set up screens and run something and drive. So we'll see what they continue to do if they're going to change something up. And Logan Pagel's going to run a 2-3 on Bulldogs as Gunbacher's going to take a three, miss it, rebound to Prio. Katz now pushes the ball down quite fast there. Kinder Connect getting a little too physical trying to reach in there for the ball. That's the app. His fourth one here early in the fourth.
And both sides, both Logan Palco and Quinter, having a few players getting in some foul trouble here late.
Yeah, you're going to watch those fouls. You got to be careful there. You know when you need a foul, but you have to know who's going to foul. Be aggressive, but also be smart with it. Katz with the throw three, gets it, brings it by three, brings it back in a little bit closer. Trailing now only by four. Briggs trying to look for something. Gets Gutenbacher in the corner. Gutenbacher gets into the Sailors. Sailors gets it back out to Briggs. Briggs is going to return it again. No. Rebounded by Katira, though. Gutenbacher now gets it back up to Katira. He looks to shoot, nothing. Packard drives, takes a little floater, puts it in. Bronze for that three with a quick two there as they extend their lead to 40-34.
And these offensive rebounds for the Bulldogs really starting to add up, giving them a lot of those second opportunity shots that they're able to capitalize on.
And that's funny. Quinter finally gets called, playing a really close off of Rio there. But it gets called for it. It's going to be his third one of the night, team second of the quarter. So looks like Graham's going to take a seat on the bench there and rest. About 5:32 left. So, full timeouts called from Logan Packer. Looking here at the end, 40-34, 5:32 left here in the game. What does Packer need to start getting into that?
We just need to start running more of an offense. We see some of those three-pointers from Katz that kind of sparks them up. You just got to run the offense, try to get it down low and get something going. Just keep eating away at the score.
Yeah. And I'm looking at it too, like they don't have like a good set offense. They're trying to tell people to come set screens and run something. So I'm wondering if they're going to try to change something up in this timeout their coach has called there, run something different on defense, try to change something to stop the Bulldogs from scoring and help them just take back the lead. But the Bulldogs, on the other hand, need to play great defense and smart defense. Have a little bit of, like you said, both teams in foul trouble. They got at least two players with three, one player with four fouls. So they're just really smart, especially when they start getting the bonus. They're going to come back out here from the full timeout. Both teams trying to play the best. Both teams still having a little bit of press on. It's going to be Logan Palco's ball coming out. And they're half of the court. Yeah, gets it to Morgan. Morgan's going to get inside the Cats. Cats trying to get in there, getting doubled by Briggs and Packard. Great defense there. Again, Briggs getting a little bit too much contact there on the line. Great defense. Just got to stop him from getting inside.
Yeah, Briggs going to be called with the foul, but got to give him a lot of credit. He crashes down to double-team Cats, and then he's quick enough to get right back out to Morgan to prevent a quick shot from Morgan.
Yeah, so it's his first one. But Cats is going to inbound it to Priol. Priol's going to miss. Priol's going to rebound it, though, as Ashmore gets it. Morgan gets back up top to Priol. Priol's looking. Looking for Cats. Cats trying to drive his way in there. Trying to look for it. Little floater. Banks it in. Brings it a little bit closer. A lot of contact. But nothing called to either on both sides. So it'll be 40-36 with about 4:50 left in the game. So he gets it inside. Trying to get up inside. Do the exact same thing. And Banks his in. Responds. Bulldogs trying not to let these, well, the Palco boys get back into this game. Logan Palco is going to try to move the ball around. We got Katira tips it away from Logan. Cats inside trying to move magic work. Gets the Sparks. Sparks holds and gets it in. Great work by Sparks on waiting and then puts it in.
Yeah, Sparks finishing, but also a terrific pass from Cats.
We'll see what Bulldogs respond with. Well, as they move the ball around, Mock it down to Briggs. Briggs to Katira. Katira with a long three. Long. Rebounded by Ashmore. So the Packers going to try to claw their way back here. Only down by four. He's going to take a long three. Contact, nothing called. Don't quite know if that was quite needed. Plenty of time left. Timeout's going to be called for the Bulldogs. There's going to be a 60-second timeout here with 3:43 left to go. Only up by four is Quinter Bulldogs here. Now the Quinter's going to try to drop some. They were down, they were up by a little bit, down slowly kitchen forward. It looks like they put Trace Kinderconnect back in as well. So he's got four fouls as well, so he's got to really watch what he's doing.
Yeah, Trace Kinderconnect would definitely be one that they want to keep in this game, especially has down the stretch. It's going to be tightening up. Make sure he just stays clean for the rest of this game.
I want to talk about Gats' long three, quick three there. There's 3:33 left, probably about 4 minutes when he shot that. I don't know if that was quite what they needed. They're only down by four. It's not. There's enough time. There's enough time to run something.
Yeah, and I get it. Cats is a terrific shooter from outside in the perimeter, but just a pull-up three like that with still time to work, and you're only down by two possessions, a four-point game. Not really a necessary shot with the amount of time that's left.
And that's what I'm thinking as well. Use your height. Get inside there. You had two good buckets up in there. Lay them in there. Try to get in there and use your body. Use the height and just trying to claw your way back here. Only down by four, so definitely going to be a really close game. We'll see what Quinter comes out as well on offense here. Try to extend their lead, not let Logan Palco get into this. Bulldogs are going to take it after the timeout. He's going to get it out of Kinderconnect. Kinderconnect's going to fake the pass. Gets it back up to Boonbacher. Boonbacher's going to get to Bridges. Briggs is going to bring it around the corner. If Morgan tried to sneak around there and get it, they're going to choose Boonbacher now. Got a corner meeting two. There's a lot of contact up top from Morgan. Kinderconnect finds it over to Boonbacher. Looks like Quinter Bulldogs are just trying to waste some time running through. Really beating that 1-3-1 that Logan Palco's running. Open corners are the both corners there outside the three. Maybe a block call. Doesn't look like Sparks was quite set there. As they were coming around, so Bulldogs are going to get underneath the hoop.
Bulldog just having a lot of terrific passes, being smart with the ball.
Agreed, yeah. They're just trying to run as much time off the clock so that way there's not enough time for them to come back and then waiting for like a really good shot. They don't want to force anything when you're up. The clock is your friend. About threw it out of bounds there from Briggs. Boonbacher saves him and looked a little relief. Boonbacher's trying to get something. Trying to foul there. Von Grio trying to get the ball back any means necessary. As Luke Caden Graham comes back in the game for Morgan. Looks like another timeout from Logan Palco. It's going to be a 30-second timeout. If you're Logan Palco, what do you do against this long offer? I think you change your defense to a man-to-man because you're trying to change it. The really open things are the corners and each thing. The Quinter Bulldogs are really finding it and really being able to get the ball passes there.
Yeah, you got
to
really put a lot of pressure on the Bulldogs and create those bad passes that you can get a takeaway on. They're just get them a little bit of chaos to where you can start something up.
Yeah, I agree with that. So, Logan Palco, quick timeout, trying to just get something going, trying to calm him down, as King Graham just came in right before that timeout. So, we'll see if he'll be any help over Morgan. An inbound on their side. So, 2:31 left here to go in the game. 42-38 Bulldogs. Here we go, Grubenbacher. Trying to see something happen. Diggs up top. Trying to keep it real high. Lose the ball, but recovered by Grubenbacher, luckily. Trying to keep away from the foul. But a timeout called from Quinter. 30-second one, so back-to-back timeout. Looked like Logan Palco was trying to foul, but looks like Trace Kinder connects. He was moving around trying not to get touched. And they about lost the ball there. Luckily for Grubenbacher, he was right there, not Logan Palco.
Yeah, when they almost lost the ball there, it was pass intended for Brick just behind him, and he tried to stop on a dime. Looked like he kind of did the splits there. He's slow to get up. He's still holding his right leg. We'll have to see if he continues in this game or not.
Hopefully he's all right, because he's been quite a big support here for the Bulldogs. So, being a senior here, he doesn't want to hurt himself too badly here. Hopefully he knows his limit. So as Quinter Bulldogs now take it here. Logan Palco. There we go. Logan Palco finally getting the foul. Only puts him to three team fouls, though. So they need two more to put him in free throws. So it's going to be on Caden Graham. That's his first of the night. Probably see another one from him. Oh! Caden Graham gets another one, but should have made a minor one in late, weigh a little bit on that, because it looked like Katz came on top of it as he came down a little bit, but of course we might not have seen him fall. So that's to put him at four, his second. And there we go. Now we're going into bonus for the Bulldogs. That one was on number 10, Case Ashmore, the team's fifth, his third. Excuse me. Caden Graham, it's going to be his third. Rims out the first one. So two shots being in close. Brings back in Morgan over Graham. We're looking for a big three probably to start out here with 2 minutes left to go. Trying to extend their lead by five to tie it up to a 3-2. And he does. Bulldog switching. It looks like Briggs is kind of limping a little bit off the court there as he takes a break. So hopefully he's going to be all right, and we'll see him tomorrow. But here we go. Minute 50 left in the game. Logan Palco finally gets the ball back. Pass looking for something. Looking for Pirillo in the middle. There's a travel, but nothing caught as Pirillo gets a bucket up in there. Now a game, one bucket game by a three. Foul call there. Now we're going to send him back to the line. It's going to be on number 10. This one's on number 10, Cage Ashmore. His first of the night. So he's got a few to spare left with 136, only trailing by three. Kateer's goal here is to take him up by four. Still a chance to make it a two-bucket game. Right now, it's just a three away from the tie. And puts it in, so now it's still a two-bucket game. So Logan Palco still has their work cut out for him. Cats drive. Another might have been traveling. Cats rebounds his own shot. Probably puts it up. Blocked by Packard. Great defense by Packard there, not allowing him to get the shot back up.
And a crucial rejection there from Packard.
Using those long arms he's got there is going to be very helpful. So now Cats trying to get it in. It was hit out by Kinderconnect. Here he goes. Ball on the opposite side there on the baseline. Down by four. Gets it in. Gets it back inside to Katz. Katz trying to get something to happen. Morgan going up for the reverse. Misses. The save by Sparks. Misses again. And a foul called on Logan Hacker. This is going to be really close here with about 69 seconds left to go in the game. 44-40, so now they're going to go to the line and shoot two, trying to extend the lead. Secure this win for the Bulldogs. That one's going to also be called on Case Ashmore, his second of the night. Name puts it in. Logan Packer now makes it 2-3 to bring it to a tie. Trying to extend the lead by six. These Salyers. And rims out, rebounded by Sparks. Still a two-shot game. Cats trying to look for something. Sparks gets back over to Cats. Cats at the 10-foot line again. Shoots it. Drains it. 52 seconds left as a timeout's called by Logan Ball. Brings it within two. It's going to be a full timeout. What a shot by Cats. They really needed that three to bring them in there.
Yeah. It's going to be Katz that's going to be the one to put it in with that clutch three right there. We've seen him hit a lot of those deep threes today, and he just continues. Hasn't been 100%, but he's hit some big ones.
Definitely. Katz has really been a real big player there. Being only he is a sophomore there, so he's got another year on top of that. Only having two seniors on the team, Keller and Morgan. So hopefully we see a lot more from this team. We'll see. Still a two-point game. It's about just under 60 seconds left to go in the game. Logan Paul might have at least one timeout left. But Quinter has how many they have. So it's going to be really close here. Both teams trying to move on to the championship for this tournament here. Trying to win it over. Quinter trying to defend their home court here. Trying to not go back home with a loss tonight. Both teams still trying to continue their three, to make it the 3-0, not 2-1.
Yeah, and we have seen Quinter in a close battle earlier this season on the road against Victoria, an overtime matchup that they won. This one's shaping up to be similar to that one.
Hopefully they can pull it out before overtime tonight, so we all can go home a little bit earlier. So here we go. Quinter's going to get the ball as Logan Packer's going to come out in their 2-2 press. As he finally gets it in. Katira, looking around. Good to Salyers. 3-0, looking, hoping he was missed the arm and knocked it out of bounds. Unfortunately, got the foul called on him. It's going to be his fourth one of the night, so he's got to be careful in the last 45 seconds left of the game. So the Salyers are going to try to extend their lead again. And he does. Still a one-bucket game. Now, Bulldogs lead by three as Cameron Morgan comes back in the game for Caden Graham.
Logan Palco does need to be aware, though, on the court there are two players with four fouls.
And what so? We'll see if he can extend it to a two-bucket lead. No! Logan Palco gets the rebound, and Katz is a dangerous man moving down the floor. Will he pull up again? He does. Quick three. Got it. Tied it up at 46 with 30 seconds left to go. Timeout called by Logan Palco. What a shot. Quick shot there. Gets it right out and fading back. That's a really nice shot there at the three line, so it wasn't as deep, but still.
Yeah, from the very beginning of the game, and Rhett Katz stood up right at the spike line and drilled it. We were able to tell that he's going to be a threat beyond the arc, and he has been a tremendous weapon for Logan Palco.
Yeah, having three fouls going into the fourth quarter, but still not having him picked up that fourth or fifth one, he's been really lucky for Logan Palco. So hopefully the Bulldogs can figure out some answer to that questionable three. So it turns out it was a 60-second call is what they had left. So bringing it down to the wire here in Quinter's house. We'll see if they can control the doghouse or if Logan Palco is going to take the lead and finish this game over them.
Couldn't have asked for a better game to end the second day of the Castle Rock Classic. It's still not even over yet.
Definitely love to see these kind of games happen. You know, when you're playing on the court, you hate it, you want to win by a lot, you want to secure it easy, but you know you got to love the adrenaline when you're out there. If you do win, you feel so much better that you beat that good of a team. So let's see what the Bulldogs do here as they try to not, they're going to try to avoid the foul, and if they do get fouled, they have to sink those two. So with here just under 30 seconds left to go in the game, here Bulldogs moving the ball down the floor. Now gets it past half court. He drives underneath Greenbacher. Salyers to Kinder connect. Kinder connect. Throws it away. Tipped off by Ashmore. And Kinder acted a foul for his fifth foul of the night. I think he was just really concerned about him going down and getting the three, getting the shot off. So Kinder connect's going to go take a seat for the rest of the night. We'll see who comes in for him. It's gonna be Johnson. Briggs stood up, but it doesn't look like Coach wants to put Briggs in too much. Briggs has just gotta sit there and wait, so hopefully Johnson's gonna be real big for him. Big man down low. So now they gotta play real good defense here with 10 seconds left to go in the game. Cats bringing down the ball, using the time, making sure there's nothing left. Hat does a spin move. Cash grabs the hold, fades away, misses, and that's way. We're going into overtime. 46-46 here for the teams. As both teams here now resets everything, fouls to count. Bulldogs now have somebody fouled out, which is Kinder connect. So let's hope. So both teams now also Logan Pyle has a lot of fouls on their end as well.
Yeah, two on the Logan Palco roster in foul trouble with Morgan and Rio, both at four fouls, but like you said, on the other side, the Bulldogs, without Kinder connect, a big piece here in this overtime.
Yeah, being one of their big speed, looks like Bridges trying to run around there, trying to stretch out his legs to make sure, so that way if he gets a chance to try to get in there and be a help to his team, he doesn't want to stand around and be something else. Honestly, neither would I be if it's the situation. It looks like Packer might have got a bloody nose. We have 50 Bridges, Cade Bridges coming in for the Bulldogs. Within minutes, 4 minutes to go here in overtime. Great game tonight, like you said, and day two, and like you said, not even over yet. We got four more minutes of this. We'll see who can really be the better team. It's about being smart, it's about being who can put off a better offense as well. So let's just see who can put in the bucket more. So here he goes with tip over against Salyers and Katz once again. And a tip picked up by Graham. So it's going to be Logan Paco's ball. Katz drives. Tries to lay one in. And he goes off the backboard, right off the bat. 46-48. Greenbacher is trying to make something happen. Swings it over to Katera. Katera looks three. Tries to respond hard. as a quick jump ball happens there. So it's going to be Quinter Bulldogs ball. So it looks like Briggs was able to muster enough strength there to come in. And so will Packen for Johnson. Briggs was being a good shooter earlier in the half. Oh my God, Salyer is trying to get it up, but blocked by Sparks, but able to get the rebound back. Briggs is recovering to Tier. Tier is looking to shoot, doesn't do it again. Briggs will shoot though. And drains it, takes the lead back, 49-48, about 3:15 left to go. Quinter pulls their press. Trying to play some great defense here. Because you got to play real good defense on Cass with him being a shooter and a drive. Doesn't do it again. No, but he gets a foul call. This is a shot, but he's going to go to the line and shoot two. That one's going to be on Packard. It's going to be his first one of the night.
And whether it's beyond the arc, driving through the lane, or trying to prevent a foul, there's really no way to stop Cat so far.
Cat's been really good tonight for the Logan Paco. As he brings it into a tie. Now it's a 49th all. There's about 3:03 left to go. And doesn't take the lead though, and this is his second rebound by Sawyers. We're going to get Grunbacher with Katir. Katura looking for something, gets it up to Grunbacher again. Trying to waste some time again. Moves it over to Katira. Katira looks to shoot, wasn't there. Briggs is underneath, off the backboard. He gets the shoot through first. This is the shot, but now he's going to go over the line.
And Briggs just hiding behind the defense on that low block, just sat there and waited, received the pass and puts it up and...
Yeah, it was great work by him. You know you aren't at your full 100% ability. As he makes his first one. You know you're not at 100% of your ability, so you've got to try to be helpful where you are. So he just sat there and waited. As his defense started to get pulled up, he was there to get in there and they would make the free throw. Get in there and shoot some free throws. As he misses the second one, they take the lead 50-49 with 2:40 left to go in the game. Cat's going to bring the ball up slowly. Crowd getting riled for him. He's going to shoot from the 10-foot line. Off though. Rebounded by Briggs. Trying to get it out so that way he can be a little more help. So we've got Katira here. A timeout called from Quinter Bulldog. 2:22 left. It's going to be a full timeout. Great work by Briggs there, by sitting there like we were talking about earlier, just being able to be a useful team. You know you're not 100%, so you're going to try to put it in. Made one, missed the second one. You still take the lead. It's still going to be up and up.
Yeah, and right now, recently, we've seen the Bulldogs really splitting a lot of their free throws, going one for two. You kind of got to wonder if they could have just been 100% from that free throw or a little bit better, not even 100%. Yep. If this would even be an overtime.
Yep, and I know when I was in high school, my coach said free throws win games. Right there, it could have been. There's a lot of fouls this game, a lot of free throw shots. So, and both sides too. Palco had their shot of free throw. They could be up and winning this game already. But they could have had the lead and missed the second one. So.
Yeah, with the way this game's shaping up, I wouldn't be surprised if it comes down to which team's going to make the most free throws.
Yep. So, we will find out here. 15 seconds left here in the timeout. Both teams fiercely trying to figure out how to get in the bucket and stop them on defense. So as Quinter is going to come out with the ball up by one here, I think their goal here is to waste as much time as they can, make a good shot, or at least go to the line and shoot. So we're going to see here. As they take it on their bench side. Be a press. Not too bad of a press. So as Logan Paco still stays with a 1-3-1, a little bit aggressive. Briggs is just going to get over to Katira. Excuse me, Grunbacher now gets to Katira. Give it back to Grunbacher right along that half-court line. No one's looking to shoot. Like I said, trying to waste some time. Packers and Sailors trying to make a move in the middle. With the Sailors as he comes out to the 3-0 and kicks it back up to the top. Is it over? Schumacher raises in the middle, sees Packard. Packard's going to go up off the glass, and now they go up by three with a minute 45 left to go.
Avery Briggs receiving the pass and is quickly getting rid of it to Packard.
And that's what seeing the floor is. That's what I love about seeing him. The Cats now. Brio with his three to tie it, and he does! 52s all around. It's a minute, just under a minute 30 now as Quinter tries to respond to that three. Riggs with his three, that's how he responds. That's the second time responding to another three of the night. Still back up 55-52. About a minute 10 left to go as Cats tries to drive, steps back out. Gets it over Prio. Prio's going to shoot again as he's off. But Morgan tips it out. And it looks like Guttenbacher's going to try to get it. And Morgan's going to get the foul called on him.
That'll be his fifth that he picks up there. So it'll be the all we see from Morgan.
Both teams now receiving one player on each team with five fouls. Logan Paul not seeming so deep in their roster as Bulldogs are. And he puts the first one in. Now it's a two-bucket game. Misses the second one. Oh, the Sellers goes over the back trying to get that rebound.
All right, they're really just an unnecessary effort from Sawyers going up and over the back.
Yeah, it's going to be his second, so they're going to have a chance to try to bring it back into a one-bucket game because right now they're trailing by four. Oh, got one more shot to maybe try to three-point game. And now Logan Packer is going to go take those spots on the lines. Puts it in. Now, 3-point game as they instantly foul, not giving them a chance. So now it looks like Katerio is going to try to extend their lead back up to four, maybe five. Like I said, it's going to come down to those free throws because either they're going to put you in the chance to shoot a three or it's going to take you out of the chance and make it a 2-bucket game.
Right now, crucial free throws.
Little too hard. So we got a chance to make it a 2-bucket game. Yeah. Ooh, still a 3-point game as Logan Packer gets the rebound. Dangerous Cats brings it down the floor. Gets the screen. No, he's going to drive it away. Gets the charge call. He is not happy about that. As the crowd goes wild over there, not allowing them to get the chance to shoot some free. That's going to be his fourth one of the night. As Logan Palco is going to call their timeouts.
Number four with four personal fouls is a scary thing to see. Although only 45 seconds left in this overtime, he's definitely one you're going to need in this.
Yeah, so you know he's got to be smart. And again, offensively, you know you need the three. He was trying to just make drive in there and make the two. But you know you've already got an offensive call early in the night. So you just got to make sure you not get a one again. So fortunately for him, that's his fourth one. So he sees with Logan Paul and Quinter Bulldogs pulled up. Because it's still a one-bucket game. We all know Logan Cats there out there is going to shoot the three ball right there because that's what you need. And we also had Prio make a three earlier to tie it up.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. It's not just Katz that you got to worry about. Prio, he's hit a few here tonight, so it's got to be on him too. You got to worry about him shooting the three ball as well.
Yep. Luckily, Briggs was able to respond to that with the three of their own to take it back up to the lead. So we'll see what they do here as Quinter and Bulldogs are going to take the ball. We'll see if they foul right out the gate again or if they're just going to let the ball run. As Briggs comes off the ball, yep, they're just going to go right out the gate. Ashmore is going to collect another foul. 41 seconds left. going to be his third of the night. So Briggs coming to the line, trying to extend their lead. And he does. Bulldogs now leading by four, two bucket game. Misses the second one, so still a 4-point game. Probably looking for Cats, one of Cats' strong threes, maybe prayers. Triple, double guarding Cats, down 24-7 now, it looks like. Ooh, picked off by the Bulldogs. It looks like Ashland's gonna pick up his fourth foul there. Tried getting it inside and just bring it back in with the two. Unfortunately, it was picked off and had to foul again. Now the Quinter Bulldogs down to 58-53 here. 24 seconds left to go in the game. Three bucket game. Excuse me. Yeah, two threes is what they need. You're probably going to see one from Cass as they double guard him. Creo misses. Rebounded by Sellers. Gutierrez tries not to get fouled. But does, so 10 seconds left to go in the game. He's gonna go to the line again. That one was on Sparks. He's also fourth tonight. Trying to make those three buckets that they need to secure the game. Misses the first one. You're good. And puts it in. That might secure it for the Bulldogs as they now need two threes and a two. As time cuts down, 4-3-2-1. Bulldogs with the win, 60-53 here. What a time in overtime. Second game going into overtime. Great fight by the Bulldogs. Both teams getting the foul trouble. Both teams figuring a way to get over their differences. So the Bulldogs will move on to the championship tomorrow evening. So let's catch you tomorrow at Quinter Bulldogs High School.